Hello, people of Nightcity. Welcome, one and all, young and old, and chromed and unchromed alike, to week four of Die Party Nightcity, a Cyberpunk 2020 adventure, starring my good friends. Hello, friends. My good friends.
Hello.
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 First up, we have AP Gaming Reel playing Dante. I want to say Inferno because
I'm just playing the bad guy. That's all there is to it.
Fiero! It's Dante Best. Fiero. Yeah. He's not the bad guy. He's just humanity.
The audience disagrees.
Well, I mean, in terms of the amount of people murdered, yours is like, what? So, you know, brah, it's good. It's fine. Yeah, that's the character you rolled, man.
And we're in fucking Night City, man. Somebody's got to make sure bitches get killed.
That's true, yeah. Bitches got to get stabbed. Up next, we have... Speaking about being stabbed, if you do get stabbed in Night City, where do you turn? You turn to Game of Sirens character, Zephyr Takahara.
Yeah. Hey.
Hey, welcome back.
That was good.
Yeah, I know, thank you. Right? If there's anything I'm really good at, it's riding a segue.
Mm-hmm. Riding one or writing one?
Both.
Either.
Yep. Speaking about both riding and writing, we have... I don't know where I'm going with this one, but fuck it. It's typical GM who's playing Einar.
I feel like writing is a perfectly fine pastime when you describe me.
Yeah.
It's a book. Fuck it.
Okay. Speaking about butt fucking, we have we have Virgil, aka Zircon 5, playing Bean Water.
Hey everybody.
We're talking about riding when it comes to Virgil. Look at that glorious mustache.
Yeah.
The mustache rap going on.
I want to say. Before the show, Virgil had on like a hoodie and looked like some sort of Mr.
Like a
Robot
soccer hooligan?
Kind of like a hooligan soccer hacker. And I was like, why isn't Ban dressed like this? Why isn't he cosplaying Ban?
I can't, I know, I could just put my hoodie up.
If you got him, like, look, he looks like a soccer hooligan now.
Yeah,
instant transformation.
On my screen, yeah, because.
Look, mate, I gotta find somewhere to jack in, but I don't wanna be seen.
I've got to find somewhere to jack in without anyone seeing me jacking off. What?
I don't want anyone seeing me jacking, okay? I've got to do it at least a few times a day, and no one can see.
Speaking about doctored order jacking, we have the one and only Chip in it, who puts a chip in it, who will be playing Barash.
So...
And Gorilla. Half the brain of Gorilla. Yeah. So, hope everyone's ready, because we're going to dive right in to Night City. Yeah.
Wow, you sound super enthusiastic.
Yeah, you know what? I was trying to pump it up, you know?
Segues, and now all of a sudden, you went
trying to pump it
out.
Anyways, so last time we played Die Party Night City... Our party spent the episode gearing up, shopping, and, well, I guess murdering people in their way. One of our party members found out the hard way that what happens to a human body after bullets enter them, that they need to, you know, recuperate. And without time on their side, recuperation is incredibly difficult. So Ban Mortar is still injured, but not overtly so. I would recommend avoiding bullets in the future, Mr. Zircon 5.
I'll try to, yeah, like not get shot by them.
Yeah.
That will be the trick.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Any trees around, just, you know, stand behind them. And we attempted to purchase some highly explosive armaments. And the only thing that exploded was the armaments themselves into the Night City ocean surrounding them. after the life of one of Zephyr Takahara's boyfriend, Garrett's contacts was murdered in the name of forward progression. And that is where...
I want to point out something about that situation, by the way.
Yeah.
Someone asked me why I was asking Zephyr if she was dating this guy. Mm. It's because she never explained who this guy was. I thought it was the person she was talking to and flirting to on the phone. It was all in character. Get wrecked. I'm method as hell.
You don't need to explain to me, Boo.
It's
I understand completely. It's fine.
He's dead. It doesn't matter.
The audience is like, Arthur, were you having a stroke or something?
Oh my god.
I know what I'm doing, guys. Trust me.
Yeah. Arthur is a method actor. You know, he knows everything and he needs to play him. So, yeah, we rejoin our crew as they, Where are you guys right now? Are you back in the safe house? Like, what's happening?
Yeah, we've gone back to the safe house because me and Zephyr had just gotten back from getting me drugs.
Mm.
Right.
The primo shit.
Mm-hmm.
The boner drugs.
The boner pills.
The life changers. I call them lifesavers now. I imagine they're in a small pack of about 8 and they're always disappointing.
Yeah. So. Oh, no, they're never disappointing. Whenever you want to like, pull out your lightsaber, man...
It's definitely more than 4 hours.
Nightcity is the... Cyberpunk 2020 is the role-playing game for you if you want to fucking pull out a lightsaber.
No, lifesavers. Lifesavers. Oh. The little tiny candies that we get in America.
We have them in Australia, too. Anyway, So, we have a couple of things. For example, Arthur has a new... a new... hurdle to overthrow in his climb to the tippy tops of Emperdom.
I mean, I'm gonna do what I do with all hurdles and get somebody else to fix the problem.
That's a good way of doing it. I mean, out of all the characters, you're the one most likely to never do it himself. Now, we last left the message on Takara's phone from Gant.
I thought that was a live call. I thought that was happening.
No, it's just a message.
No, it was a text message that said why. Okay.
Why? Yeah. So what is everyone doing right now in the safe house? I mean, Gorilla was never left behind in the other place, so maybe if you wanted to follow that lead, you totally could.
Wait, Gorilla is where?
He's with you.
Oh, good.
Yeah, back up in the apartment where he belongs. Mm-hmm. The rest of us. The rest of the team.
Nope. No, he was not a member of our team.
He is clearly a member of our team.
He was at the lab when we went to the deal.
Oh, he was?
Oh, yeah, we had dropped him off. Yeah, okay. We went to Ship's place.
So there you go.
Because Arthur won't let me have any real pets. He just let me have these fucking
gorilla animals. Cannot stay in my apartment. Only the puppy dog. Oh. And only... if our young Meditech gets excitable.
What?
I would have
the
no
next
idea.
Time she tries to call me Dan, I'm going to kill the dog.
Ah.
We have problems. Einar likes that dog now.
What you have against Gorilla? Gorilla be great pet. Greater than some puppy.
So the camera flashes over to Gorilla. He's literally just laying on his back, scratching his crotch right now in the cage, and then it flashes back to you guys.
The gorilla is going to be used as bait for our next operation. I have nothing against him. It's just he may, in fact, die in the line of duty, just like your cyber wolf, and it will be very sad, and I will weep tears.
Well, actually, I plug into his head two chips for weapon use. One rifle, I give him AK. If you can procure me a minigun, he can use heavy weapons.
I definitely just look at you. I'm like, if I
are
can't
you sure we can't keep him?
A grenade launcher, I definitely can't get a gorilla. Listen, we're going to have to work on the arms deal again. Zephyr, what's the street deal? What do I need to do in order to acquire these weapons from someone slightly more competent?
I don't know, maybe have cash on hand. That might have helped. Or how about maybe not throwing C6 under somebody's car?
We had a discussion. No one brought the briefcase. From now on, Einar, you're going to carry my briefcase everywhere.
You know, it's
too expensive. We should go rip off some BTL chips.
We're not going to. No, first off, we're not going to rip off anybody. That's stupid. I make way more money than a street drug dealer.
Lord Hellison, I must protest. I'm afraid carrying a briefcase is going to make it difficult for me to protect you. Perhaps
no,
one of the less...
No, you don't have to physically hold on to the briefcase. Just attach it to the back of your armor or something. I'm giving the briefcase to you because you are the most trustworthy member that would not rip me off.
Einar is just beaming. He's so happy. He's like, of course, Lord Hellison, I will take this responsibility... And I will discharge it with the utmost fervor.
Now, how many kilos is the briefcase?
I know that I need you to sign. In the ancient Icelandic tradition, I am going to, upon my death, bequeath you with my title as Gothi, and so you will carry on your Viking legacy as a justice priest. I only ask one thing, is that if I'm killed by Samantha Tallis, you murk the shit out of that bitch. Just sign here and here.
Don't sign anything, Einar.
Einar takes out his mono knife and just slashes down his palm and just puts a big bloody palm on the documents. As Dante would know.
It's an electronic document, Einar.
He's still going to do it.
I appreciate your commitment to the old ways, but you will need to sign... in a manner that the tablet is capable of registering.
So the tablet's like, please reinsert signature.
Blood dripping down.
Yeah.
Signature.
Let me
ward
that out for you. Get that clean, and then you can. Here's your stylus. Just try with that one then.
I'm gonna look at the stylus with my hand and like just try to like, place the blood with the stylus.
Signature recognized. Hello, Ina. No.
Yeah, this has been done enough that he had Ben actually write him up a custom program to recognize blood on the screen.
Here's the deal. This is where we currently stand. Zephyr, I need you to acquire more street weapons dealers. Do we know that those drugs are the wrong drugs?
No.
Those drugs are the right drugs.
Okay. So,
they're semi the right
drugs. I
thought
drugs. He wanted
some
sort of combat drugs and ended up getting boner pills. Am I wrong about that?
They just also
like
give boners.
They're like in between.
Yeah,
this
is like, imagine like regular like andro supplements like steroids are going to increase the resting testosterone, like the serum testosterone in your bloodstream, which will also have a beneficial effect on your sex drive.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, kind of similar.
Yeah, so that's much what you get.
It's like, no one even knows whether they were trying to, you know, develop combat or sex drugs, but they ended up with both and were very happy.
Exactly.
Okay. So,
they're like,
yeah.
This is a niche
you
can fill.
Until he gets his hands on you and... You're the one that he's going after.
Lady Freya has assured me that these are the correct correct ritual herbs for what
Do your country a favor and grab a rod.
Yeah,
it'll make some
I mean, like,
happy.
If you think about it, if you're in combat and all the blood is in your penis, it's very hard for you to bleed. So, you know.
It's like a
also, you're very
extra
hard
to blood. You bleed out, like, a minute slower.
Unless you get shot in the crotch and then it's just like downhill. Yeah.
So the point is, you do have the drugs you're looking for, or something like them,
as
so I don't need
I
to
know,
be like, we
Lady
need more
Freya
drugs.
Lady Freya has assured me these are the correct drugs. The correct ritual herbs.
Yes, very well. Excellent. You have the drugs that you're looking for, which is perfect. Everything is fine in that regards. So, status and mission report right now. Einar, if Samantha Tallis kills me, you make sure to kill her dead back. That deals with that problem. By the way,
Lord Hellison, I beg your pardon, but I must interrupt. Why do we not simply, if she is an enemy of the Valar, and if she's an enemy of you, Lord Hellison, why do we not simply kill her first?
I have been ordered not to kill her first.
But Lord Hellison,
who
I am your vassal.
Yeah, he hasn't been ordered to do nothing.
Has
exactly,
Heimdall. Consider Odin's orders to me that I not eliminate this foul threat. Truly, she is as if hell upon me. It is very tempting
to
destroy her, as every ending involving her involves cowardly deceit and death. But I cannot, at this time, afford to take her on in a straight-up combat. I'm going to have to wait for her to make the first move.
I could at the very least write a bot that crawls the net for her comments and makes derogatory statements.
Yep. Do that.
You just make a troll bot to follow her around.
Ben, that is currently your job. Make sure to create a troll bot that follows them at the palace around and
excellent.
Continues to pester her on the internet. Now, Barash,
Dante,
I have
will you help me?
Important mission for you. I'm going to be acquiring a warehouse. I need you to science it up. I don't need it to actually work, but it needs to appear as if it is currently a testing facility for your cyber animals.
Can
if
I do
it
this?
Becomes an actual facility to do that, perhaps it will, I don't know, but either way, it is going to be a gigantic trap that we will be laying for our foes, the Midnight Animal.
I do this.
And you are going to be storing Go Gorilla there. They are a secret weapon.
I
am not attempting to get Go Gorilla killed. In fact, this is a brilliant plan to lure them into close combat with Go Gorilla.
That's great. Well, I could help out. You know, I know where to get some good recycled electronics and rig that stuff up, make it look all fancy.
Yes, perfect.
So, just
as long as I have the resources.
Takahara, need better weapons. Einar, watch everyone's back. Ben, Trollbot plus discount electronics. And Barash, I will be acquiring a warehouse for you. I need you to make it science. Everyone good? Excellent. Thank you so very much. I have several reports to turn in, I-5, Z-21s, and just in general, I need to begin briefing the staff on Samantha Talis.
So, Siren, what were you trying to say during all of that?
So, Dante, I don't know if you happen to have somebody that I could talk to for, you know, weapons, since you blew the one up I had.
If you wanted to, you could make a streetwise check. Do you have streetwise?
Ooh. Wait, I missed that, right? Because I was stayed at home because I was injured.
Yes.
Right? Yeah. Like,
I might
blow
actually
up
be able to do it.
Yeah.
Well,
I mean, it'd only be like it'd only be like a 10 for you know, rumors, a 15 to understand to understand that there's someone out there that you could contact, or just take a bit of time. A 20 would be like you have a direct contact with them, and a 25 would be like, you know, you could just speed dial that motherfucker.
So. All right, let me see what I got. Okay, here goes nothing.
Hey, alright.
What'd I get?
You got a 6.
Cool.
Yeah.
Nice.
Plus 9, so, yeah. Okay. So, you are... you do know of some people who would be able to help you, but... again, unlike... what was his name? Was it, like, Elisha?
Something Elisha, like yeah.
Unlike Elisha, this guy... Oh, hang on. Let me just quickly spoof out a character
name,
here.
Name Marino.
Yeah. This person, his business dealing won't come for free. Not only will you have to pay for what you want, but you'll also have to pay for the pleasure of doing business with this person.
Oh, I'll give him Dante. It'll be fine.
There you go. That's one way of handling it. All right, so what are you trying to do? You trying to contact this person?
Yeah, I'm gonna have to try. Yeah.
Okay. All right. So this one is his name is Clark Cansey. Clancy. It's a male.
Clark Cansey Clancy. Hey, call him.
But okay. He's known on the street as just R.
R.
Mm-hmm.
R. As in R.
As in
R.
as in the letter R.
Okay.
All right, so tell
are
me.
Are you serious?
Tell me how you go about contacting R.
Let's see. I'm going to probably a roundabout way. I'm going to have to get a hold of Tabitha. I'm going to figure that she knows him from like school or something.
And Tabitha, remind me who that was.
Yeah, bringing that up right now. She is the one that hired me in the clinic.
I see. Okay. So she's the old, the mothery type one.
Yeah, she's like in between, yeah.
Okay. All right.
So, it just happens to be somebody that she's acquainted with. He probably came in to the clinic one time, and he was in really bad shape, and so she helped him out. And
okay, so do you have any sort of social skills? Like, what sort of social skills do you have on your character?
Do you have any kind of social skills?
No.
I am unsociable.
I don't think I do. Let me take a look at your skills real quick.
What do you need?
Because this will put a strain on the relationship that you have with her, for example. Wow, you really don't have any. Oh, okay.
I'm working on it.
Yeah, so you don't have any... Oh, you're trying to get persuasion and fast talk. Interesting.
Right.
Shit. Okay. Alright, so... Yeah, I mean, like, tell me how you convince her to sort of set this up. Because imagine a scenario where, like, you know, she is a clinic leader for a gang, right? And in a lot of cases, she might have done what she did to fix this person so that she could get a benefit out of it. That's how... I mean, no one does anything in Nightcity for free, even if they say that they do. So in her case, I imagine it was to secure... something. I mean, he is a fixer after all. It might have been drugs, it might have been medical supplies, it might have been actually weapons itself. Who knows? Mm-hmm. But the fact of the matter remains is that she would have to give you her contact in order to make this happen. And
I'm really worried about that.
Rumor has spread about you burning someone else's contact in the process, then it's going to be immensely difficult. But I doubt by this point it has. Just keep that in mind. Because that's essentially what's happened with your last attempt. So.
Right. Okay, so I'm going to call her up.
Okay.
Ring, ring, ring.
Takahara, hello.
Oh, Miss Tabitha, hi. How are you?
Well, if I wasn't up to my elbows in gangster blood, I would be okay, but, you know.
Yeah, I hear you on that one. I got a little of a problem. I need to get some weapons, and I heard that you're somebody I could talk to about that.
Come now. I don't have an armory of weapons in the back. Unless you want to just stab people with heroin or something.
Dirty
you're
needles.
So funny. Nice. But, and I know that you know somebody. And if you were willing to help me out and get me in contact with this person, I promise, you can put me in the clinic every single day for the next month, and I will be there.
She sort of like...
from open to close.
She sort of like waits a little bit on the other end of the line, and then she's like, now how the hell did you find that out?
I have my ways.
You've always been
and, you know, I learned them all from you.
A whole month of clinic work, huh?
A whole month. So that you can take it off.
Well, that would be impossible, but having the extra hands around here wouldn't be so bad. Are you really going to, just out of character, are you really going to offer her an entire month's worth of clinic work here?
Yes.
Because that seems
it's
like...
it's worth it.
That would seem like it would really easily step into game time, and that might be a really hard thing to keep.
I mean...
that's the only thing I'm going to say.
What she doesn't know is that Gorilla is the one that's going to be going in to do the work.
just put
it's
first aid in the chip, you know?
It's also up to our DM to figure out a way to get your character out of the clinic work, so...
Oh, wow.
We're going to make a deal here on the idea that Dave is going
to
get you
if
out
anything,
of that.
I'm going to try to get you into it more than out of it, so, you know, if you want to offer an entire month...
I am willing, because a month is a lot, for the fact that she may or may not get her contact blown up in the end.
Okay, so... Just so you're aware,
your contact will not die at the end of this.
I didn't say that.
So
but I'm just saying,
let's just reiterate exactly what you're offering here. You're offering your contact that you will work full time for a month in the clinic every day.
Bye, Zephyr.
8 hours a day for 30 days.
Yeah.
Okay. Just putting that out there. So she scratches her chin and she's like, Well, I'll pay you the basic rate, much like an intern would get. You understand that I'm not willing to give out my contacts for free, but I'm also not willing to not pay you for your work.
Zephyr, who is that on the phone?
Shh! Dante! Quiet.
I don't know why people are always making phone calls in my house without telling me.
So
it happens
I, like,
all the time.
I put my hand over the phone and I'm like, Dante, I swear to God, if you ruin this for me, I will, I don't know, sick the
what
gorilla
is it that
on
I'm
you.
I'm ruining?
I'm Nothing. Trying to get your contact.
Well, just offer them a giant briefcase full of money.
Yeah, and I need, like, an automatic weapon of some sort.
Yeah.
Heimdall, you don't have weapons. I have many.
Listen, I literally hear you offering... You work for me, Zephyr. You don't work for this other person. Let me talk to them.
Tabitha?
Yeah?
There's a handsome gentleman that wants to talk to you.
Oh, interesting.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, Dave,
I'm
going to
apologize
on?
Ahead of time in case he's a big dick, because sometimes he acts like that. But he is very handsome.
All right. Put him on.
Here, hey, Dante.
While this is going on, I'm going to grab Heimdall and yank him into my room, like my murder dungeon of weapons, and just with the glee of a child on Christmas, start showing him all of my weapons.
I imagine it's one of those cases where, like, you know, most people would use, like, their closets for, like, storing clothes. You have, like, your clothes in the corner in a pile, but all your guns are inside.
Oh, yeah, like, nice and partially desk. Disassembled, yeah. Clean, like, yeah, just grenades and rockets laying scattered around the room.
And I'm just trying to be as polite as possible, because I know that this is just like when I show people my floppy disk collection.
The antique.
This one has Cop Story on it. It's very good.
Yeah. Like, Corp Story is a classic.
Day of the Tentacle on 27 floppy disks.
Oh, no.
Cool. So, since Dave said I could rearrange my stats as long as I still left one in handgun, I put 4 in heavy weapon.
Holy fuck. Everyone's going heavy weapon? Is that what we're doing now?
No. What
rifle?
That means that, like, yeah, you could totally... I have a crew-served weapon. We could give you, like a machine, like an actual heavy machine gun.
Yeah.
Bane Mortar's on the floor!
I mean, I also have that level of heavy weapon operations. I'm looking to get some sort of anti-material rifle.
Yeah.
Okay. But yeah, Ben, maybe we could... listen, we need to go get an Osprey and then attach this crew-served weapon onto it, and then we'll just fly you around in your crippled state. And allow you to shoot at them.
Exactly. I follow the Adam Coble style of GMing, and I'll never give you guys a grav tank.
We don't need a grav tank. We simply need a VTOL.
Alright, so...
Actually, I could do that.
So, oh, Takahara hands you, Dante, the phone.
Excuse me, can I ask for your name, miss?
It's Tabitha. Who am I speaking
Tabitha.
With?
Hello, my name is Dante Fierro. If you are looking for pictures of me, you can find them at www.dantefierro.info.
All right, you hear
typing. I don't know how Takahara managed to find out that I do, in fact, have an enormous penis, but there are several pictures of it on that particular website.
Just scroll down.
Yeah, so you hear scrolling, and she's like, oh my. Oh.
I'm afraid that Takahara works for me to some extent. I understand she volunteers at the clinic. I can't spare her for 30 days at 8 hours a day. Even if she is being paid at basic rate or whatever. What if I just gave you a giant briefcase full of cash instead?
Listen, I'm not really interested in money, especially after seeing what you've got on offer.
Oh my god!
Yeah!
Then what is it you are looking for, Miss Tabitha?
Have you ever played house before, Mr. Dante?
Oh, fuck my life.
I'm just like, I have in fact watched the series House. I found it somewhat pedantic.
It's very much like that, yes. Except imagine a lot more doctor's outfits and a lot less doctor's outfits.
Are you propositioning me?
Very smart. This one's a thinker.
I did graduate from Cambridge Multiplex Ultraversity.
It sounds like he did.
Well, if I'm understanding our deal here correctly, we will go out on a date, and then you will introduce Zephyr to your contact.
Who said anything about a date?
Well, I did, I think.
How about you just make your way down here tonight, and we can talk about the deal in a little more personal setting.
Okay, I think I turned to Zephyr and I put my thumb over the mute button. I definitely put the mute button on, and I'm like, Zephyr, is this person I'm talking to on the phone attractive?
Of course she is.
Rate it on a scale of 1 to 10.
Give me, actually, you know what? Roll me a 1d10 there.
I'm like holding like a giant automatic weapon, and I'm just like, you need another reservation? Probably just call this time. It was quite a hassle.
Shit. Hold on. Stuff's not working.
Don't fuck Go. This up.
I fucked Don't it fuck up. Up. What the fuck is going on?
If it's not at least an 8, the deal's off. It, you're going to be working at the clinic forever.
Yeah.
1d10, right?
1d10, please, yeah.
Wow. Oh yeah.
So what do you say? Yeah, what do you
all
say?
Natural
personality.
All natural one.
Siren, what do you say? What
bubbly personality.
Oh, she's very cute.
She's adorable.
Okay.
Seriously?
You have no training in deception, right? Like, you're awful at all social things.
Could she be like a...
Hang on, we gotta
tumble bad as well? Jesus. Okay.
Yeah, she's she's a usual 40-year-old. She looks fine in scrubs.
No, just watch it be like she's like a perfect 10, except for just a hideous mole on her face, and that's what brings it down to a nat 1.
Oh, God.
She's a 10, but she has that disease where you're extremely hirsute, like very hairy, but her uniform covers it. So when she takes her clothes off, that's when he realizes.
So what's persuasion and fast talk under? That's under empathy skills, right? Yeah.
Yes.
Oh, she's got a high empathy too.
7. Okay. They are violently opposed to anything you want. Roll a 1d10. On a 1 through 4, they attempt to physically harm you. No, we won't do that.
Oh my god.
It's just like, you tried to set me up with who? Whack!
Arthur, oh, that would be bad. You are 100% aware of what Takahara is attempting to do. It's like when you put on a date and you're there to just wingman because, you know, the other one, your friend doesn't want you to... interfere with his romantic intentions, but the friend is like just completely unattractive, just to every degree. Like, there's something, like, she's not, like, she's not, like, obese or anything like that. She's not, like, you know, like, garish to look at. But this character, for the most part, there's just something about her that just fucking irks you the wrong way. And something about her face, maybe. Maybe it's, like, the angle of her nose or something. And it's just, like, to the point where you look at her and just, like, I can't tell if you are a bad painting or, like, what's going on here? Like, that's the sort of thing that you get when you see her. But in terms of, like, what Takahara is telling you, it is a fucking atrocious lie. She's almost sweating from saying what she said.
I mean... Zephyr. You know, Dante, how far are you willing to go to get this contact of yours? It's all up to you, I suppose. I want to
be extremely clear here, Zephyr. Acquiring these contacts is your job, and the fact that I must do what I'm about to do speaks very poorly on you, and you, as the people on the streets say, owe me now. And I take the thumb off the mute button, I'll be like, what time again?
I'll make time for you. You just show up. And then you hear, like, her audibly smile through the phone, like, you know, like that.
Oh, no.
I mean, I'm already texting the Arthur,
at any point in the game, if you're uncomfortable, just tell Dave, no, that doesn't happen in the game. Not okay. I don't want that squish sound in my ear. Let's move on. I
smile audibly. But yes.
That is so good.
I definitely go on this date.
All right. Okay.
Is it a date? Is it a date or is it like a Netflix and chill date?
It's like it's literally a booty call. It's 100%.
Okay, it's not even Netflix. Netflix. You don't even have the pretense of Spanish. Netflix. It is just
Spanish subtitles.
You just show up on her doorstep in a Speedo greased up from the neck to your toes, ready to go. I got
Dante, I understand that I owe you, and so I will put this out there. When Garrett comes to kill you for killing
his... You don't know he's an assassin, though, right?
Yeah.
You just know that he's kind of a badass?
Well, he seems pretty pissed off right now, so I don't know what he's willing to do. So, I mean, at least I'll try to get between you and him.
What? No, absolutely not. I forbid it.
Why?
We don't have nearly enough waivers for that. That's Einar's job. Einar's job is to get between me and homicidal maniacs.
Oh my gosh. He's not homicidal. He's probably really mad. Maybe they were friends. Did you ever think about that?
Well, just tell him he said some very unkind things towards you.
That he
tried hitting on you or something. Just tell your friend that. Anyway. Your social problems are not my problems. I have a date to go on. The rest of you have jobs to do.
All right, so...
Einar, get me the goddamn car.
And a couple condoms.
Couple?
I'm going to put my head in my room, like layers and layers, like chains and chains of linked ammunition looped around my neck. I'm like, Lord Helsin, I'm introducing Heimdall to all of the weapons.
Hey, Dante, do you want one of those pills that Einar got?
Well, you don't know it's a boner pill. No one
Dante's
knows it's a boner pill.
Literally laughing like, I don't need those pills. Don't
worry. Have you seen her yet?
I am 100% erect at all times.
I mean that other lesser men have those problems, but not me.
No, just watch. Like, you have to roll like a cool...
Can I buy the Mr. Stud?
You can, yeah. It is...
Yep, I did.
You actually have it? Oh, wow, okay.
I have a stud and I have the contraceptive implant, so that's true. Need your stupid condom.
Yeah, you're good to go. You're DTF, you know. Alright,
By
the way, safe sex is extremely important, people. Don't, whatever I just did, probably don't do that.
Yeah.
Did you ask for condoms or you just want the car?
I asked for you to bring the car, not condoms.
Okay.
Okay, so... While, you know, Dante is going to his fated meeting of the minds, what is everyone else doing?
I'm driving him there.
Yep, that's fair. You can be his bodyguard on the move.
Mm-hmm.
Arthur, this is important. What are you wearing?
His Metal Gear. His Metal Gear.
His full Metal Gear.
I have to get out of the Metal Gear for this one.
No, just have... I have a hinged cod piece on mine. Why can't you?
Oh my gosh.
It's time I just leave the Metal Gear behind in the house. Good man. I literally Iron Man out of it. I just like walk away and the Metal Gear stays standing in place.
It like puts its hand out and it's like...
I'm wearing my executive businessman wear.
Perfect, yes. This will help with her fantasy very easily. I'm wearing
like Palestinian keffiyeh and like bright white robes. You know what? I look kind of like... Who was it in Tron 2? Tron Legacy? Jeff Gold... It's not Jeff Gold. It's the other Jeff.
It's
Jeff Bridges.
Jeff Bridges.
Yes, yeah. I look like him when he's wearing like the white like robe outfit.
Okay. Yeah, I can get down with that.
And it's made out of like several thousand thread count. Listen, there isn't a number to describe how many thread count this thing has.
Okay, so it's like it's almost to the point where it's so silky it's falling off you.
Yes.
Okay.
Some of the threads are in higher and lower dimensions than we can comprehend, guys. Like,
the thread count is a theoretical.
I imagine like if you were to cut it, it would just get longer instead of like being separated. Like that's how that works. Yeah. Okay. So what is everyone else doing while this meeting of the genitals is happening? Thanks, Jet. That's a good one. Yeah.
I guess I would scout out warehouses that might have some
equipment
in them.
So
I actually might inquire about Band to help me search for that. So if we find a warehouse that already has like equipment that I could use after the fact that it gets gunned down, you know, like milling equipment, because I want to start machining and producing stuff.
So here's one of the things that I'm not 100% comfortable with in this system, and that is like real estate purchasing. So for the sake of this show, I think we're just going to hand wave it, but there might be rules in the book. So if anyone's is like a super super understanding of the rules,
there's a monthly fee.
I know there is. Yeah. I'm just trying to work out like so it's related to like I'm pretty sure it goes the rent is it's a certain cost, and then it's like times location based on where it is.
We want this to be in like the combat zone in the shittiest part of town. We want to make it as easy as possible to hit. And we want to make it look like it's super undefended, but on the inside be like completely.
Yeah, I'm just trying to find the page where it. So maybe you guys can spend a bit of time
like,
just talking.
Maybe. I'm like online and I'm looking like for specifically for properties that are super cheap because they have like contaminated soil, so there can be no housing or anything there.
No, there would be housing. You completely underestimate the type of shit people are willing to live in Night City. So.
Okay. Well, then maybe it's just like close to like a power generator or something.
If you're looking,
land value is super low.
If you're looking specifically for cheap places, right? It's you have to go to the outskirts of the combat zone.
Okay.
Like we're talking like the combat zone is like all the built up areas and stuff. Street level, a lot of shit happens in the combat zone, but. Outside is where literally like gangbangers and stuff like that will be most prevalent. So in terms of a place, you know, you could get a place on the cheap and then make it stupidly like well defended.
But no, actually I like the idea of having it close to like a power substation because I have a brilliant idea for how I want to defend this place.
Okay. God,
you said that, my blood pressure immediately spiked. Like, I'm now afraid. My perfect plan is going to be ruined.
In theory, Dante is an agent of order, and we are all agents of chaos, pulling at the fabric of his plans every time.
Have we established what accent Barash is using this week? Has that happened yet?
I'm still using the same accent.
No, you gotta switch again. Come on, we've established this now.
Okay.
You have the same accent all the time. That's weird. That's Band's thing.
You change it every week.
Did I change it? No, I just changed it last week because just before last week. I was using.
All right, fine. I'm wrong.
Well, I mean, if you want to, I could probably do like an audio.
I like this so much better. See, let's take a poll from the audience on that one.
Yeah. We should do like a weekly. Yeah, what next week? What voice does Chip do?
SoundCloud okay, listeners, so, this one specifically to you. Let us know. Tweet at Henley.
So let to get All right. So the combat zone. We're looking at so how many rooms do you want this place to have realistically?
Well, it's a warehouse, so it only needs one.
But if we go by bedroom scale, right? How many of those do you want this? Because that's how I'll make.
Yeah, it's
got to
be. It's got to be like six rooms stacked together. It's got to be like a gymnasium at least sized, right?
Okay.
Like a high school gym.
Yeah. Okay.
I mean, it's got to be large enough that we can pack it full of explosives and ammunition, and then either shoot our way out or just blow.
No. Midnight. No need to worry. Leave it all to Barash.
Say that, and I'm like freezing in terror and fear.
Have faith. Think about how good all my roles have gone on the computers.
Alright, so we're looking at 1,200 euro bucks per month, but the down payment on that is double. So
I'm going to just resource this away and have the company. Because we're using it for official company business.
Fair enough.
Unofficial company business.
So for the most part, like let's see, like so what type of qualifiers are you looking for in terms of location and like defensibility and like maybe just like just what it's located
so it's
near and stuff like that
in the rough area so that it's not in a like protected by a nice corporation or anything like uh-huh. No good corp like thinks of it as their territory. So, sure. You know, in the shit zone, near a power station, we probably were talking about it, and I'm like, wouldn't it be cheap to get, like, a power station, you know, property? And he's like, no, not Nightcity. But then he gets the idea, and he's like, okay, we definitely need to buy a power station. So, yeah, ground level, at least the size of, like, a high school gymnasium where you could have, like, bleachers and, like, a nice, you know... sports
okay.
area.
Are we going to do the crate dragon fight in a different campaign now? Like, are we going to sell rights to us killing Midnight Animal?
Sure. I mean, why the fuck not? I mean, you're a businessman.
We need to record it and televise it as well.
Yeah. So, yeah.
And make money off of that.
Give me a library check real quickly, please, Mr. Van Mortar.
Alright.
See if we can find something. Okay, again, so 10 through 10 is like you find something, it's whatever. 15, you find something suitable. 20, you find something that a person is trying to literally get rid of to the point where it's like, you know, cheaper, where you can negotiate a cheaper price. 25 and up, it's even cheaper, right?
Okay, I have a question about IP. Can I spend IP, like, at any old time, or is that, like, a specific time?
Yeah, absolutely,
time?
Okay, yeah.
Because earlier, I bought a point of athletics earlier.
Okay, so you spent 10 points in athletics, or did you not have athletics? What was your athletics?
I don't have athletics.
Okay, so it's 10 points to go from 0 to 1.
Yeah, okay, that's what I spent.
Yeah.
Correct. And I go around looking through the,
Oof. Oh, terrible holes.
Okay, so what's that? That's tech? And you rolled a 2? Okay. You just can't get it together. Like, there's literally nothing out there.
These rolls are worse.
Like, you've scoured the internet, and you just can't find anything.
Like, look, everything's too big. This place, I mean, we can't afford this place, or this place is enormous. We wouldn't even, you know... A lot of these, they want us to rent multiple stories of these buildings. It's just not happening.
Yep. Barash, what are you doing right now?
I am working out some plans. If you want me to roll now for just like a... Well, basically my thought is...
Tell me your plans.
My thought is we're going to get this warehouse, right?
Well, and I'm gonna hopefully. Eventually.
I might have eventually. To like buy a just like some fucking like an empty lot and build my warehouse.
Well, you might have to try rent. And like what we might end up doing, since you can't find anything for rent, you might try and muscle someone out of like a, you know,
ooh, that's a good idea.
Some sort of chop shop or something like that.
I actually know where one of those is, but here's the idea.
Mm-hmm.
Is we get the chop shop look in place and we get it looking like it should be, and then, you know, install just like some fake turrets. I'm pretty sure I can jury rig something that looks like a turret up all around the perimeter, all that type of stuff. And then on the inside, mm-hmm. basically protect the surgical environment with a Faraday cage, and then in all of the spare equipment, set up superconductors. And so when the midnight animal enters in, I turn it on and that thing lights up like an EMP.
Okay. You mean you want it to have the same effect as an EMP?
No, it's just going to be lightning everywhere.
Oh.
Except for the Faraday cage, because it's grounded and it protects from lightning attacks. So it's just going to be giant arcs of lightning striking everything. It's going to be as if Mjolnir itself was just slammed down and a lightning storm goes off.
Yeah, that's going to be a pretty tough roll, man. Not only will you have to try and gather the resources for that, which you would have to mix with Arthur, but... putting that together would be very tough.
That's why having it near like a electrical place would be amazing.
That too, you know, it's going to require some.
Okay,
juice.
So I'm going to look for like a place that's that has all those things, but is not for rent, Dave.
Oh my god, yo,
preferably
are we back
like
yet?
A chemical producing facility or maybe a food producing facility.
Yeah, give me another roll. We'll see what you get.
Are we still at the hookup for Arthur and the clinic owner?
Is there something wrong with roll 20?
It's literally just rolling ones.
Roll like me another one, just real quickly. Ones. Let's see if it's still rolling ones. Just the kicks and giggles. No,
there we go.
Okay, so, alright, so not the fumble. 5.
It's just that you guys are bad at rolling, obviously.
You make it worse. Alright, fair enough. So yeah, no, you find some places. They just happen to be all controlled by the local gangs. I will find you a gang.
It's controlled by Midnight Animal.
Huh. Nah, nothing.
God, we were looking for them anyways.
Oh, we found them. let's see. We are looking for... Alpha, let's... so, Takahara, let's go to you before we do anything else. What are you trying to do right now?
So I text Garrett back. Hey, what's going on?
Mm. Can we have a deception roll?
Oh, no, she doesn't.
It's text messaging.
Not from her.
I know.
Jesus.
I know.
Okay, so yeah, you get a text back and it's just like, work.
So what was that text about?
Well, you get another text back and it's just like, you know.
It should just be a picture of the wreckage.
So I text him back, enlighten me.
You dumped the truck into the drink, so...
Yeah, so, yeah, so maybe there is a photograph being sent to you right now. Do you download it? All right, it takes you a couple
of
minutes.
That's going to be like, yeah, and it's going to be like $3 on your phone bill.
Yeah, it's pretty rough. But yeah, you get it. It's literally a picture of Dante throwing C4 at a thing. And then the next picture is a picture of, but you know, he's in a full suit. And the only one that's there that's not in a full suit, right, is, so his face is covered and everything like that. And the only one who's not covered by anything is you, because you were the only one there without a full suit on.
Right.
And then the next picture is the car literally flipping in the air with fire brimming off of it and going into the water. And then you just looking angry, but like Dante just shrugging in his like power suit or something like that.
So I text him back. Yeah, that was all Dante.
You don't get a text back.
course not. Everybody's gone?
I mean, Band and Barash are still here. Doing their work. Like, but they're busy. They're busy, like,
looking at. I'm pretty pissed, actually.
Band is, like, plugged in, but you can see he's agitated. And Barash is, like, I don't know, elbow deep in grease right now or something like that.
All right, so I sent another text. Is everything okay? I mean, everything's not okay. I understand that. But, dot, dot, dot.
Chip, give us 10 minutes and then you can. Can you hear us, Chip?
Yeah, I can still hear you. I just can't see anything.
Okay, yeah, we'll frozen. Yeah, we'll do it on a break. So you get what was the text you sent?
I said, is everything okay? I know that everything's not okay, but dot dot dot.
You get a text message back saying, tell me where you are.
So I send him the address of the place.
Okay.
You're sending him to my fucking address?
You're not here?
I know. I'm saying this out of character.
Give me the best? Takahara.
That's why I have a safe house that I don't tell anyone about.
This is the safe house?
He's like, I'm saying this out of character. That is my actual house. Because I can't believe it.
I have a safe house I won't tell any of you about because I don't invite assassins to the place I sleep at.
Takahara.
I don't know he's an assassin. He's my boyfriend.
Takahara, give me a luck check real quick, would you?
I want to roll a one.
No, that's you want to roll a one. You want to roll a one. No, that's what you want.
I used up all the ones on my real estate checks.
So let me remind everyone. So in order to pass... Oh, no, you didn't. In order to pass a luck check in this new system that we have, it's much like a body roll. Where you roll a 1d10 and you have to get lower than your luck skill. In the case of Takahara, her luck skill is a 4, but she rolled an 8. So that means that she was unlucky in this instance. So the way that I will do the rolls is anything outside of your control, i.e. an NPC doing something or acting a particular way or reacting a particular way in this instance, that she doesn't have any control over, especially because she's not actually talking to the guy. She can't control his actions. And if she wanted something positive to happen in her favor, then she would need to roll a positive luck check, which she didn't do. So, yes, something will happen. All right, speaking about something happening, let's swap over to... The fated.
I'm not rolling anymore tonight.
Dante and Einar. What are you... What is... Like, maybe you're driving and, like, maybe Tabitha. The radio is on in the background. Does any sort of conversation happen inside of the car on the way to them?
I imagine as we're driving, I'm just driving as I normally do, paying a little attention to the road.
So maybe in the background it's like... And then the midnight animal was all like... And then they decided to blow up a building for some reason. Police speculate that it was something to do with the fact that the wife was apparently sleeping around. Not a lot was left inside of the building explosion aside
from...
Turn
that radio off. I'm tired of feeling about our handiwork.
Click it. Lord Helson, is there any specific threat that I need to be aware of as we go into this next mission?
Jesus, I don't know.
Do you require my assistance in any way aside from keeping you physically safe?
I'll need you to pick me up when I'm done. You're going to want to be here when I call?
5 minutes, just 5 minutes.
Lord Helson, I cannot leave you alone going into an unknown location.
And just stay outside.
Lord Helson, there may be assassins waiting inside. Bring you low.
I agree with that.
You specifically told me of this woman, this... Ariana Grande.
Samantha Talis. It's Samantha yes. Talis. Listen, do not speak that name to me. Ever since she slapped Taylor Swift at the 2018 Grammys, I've just never forgiven her.
I'm gonna let you finish.
If this Samantha Talis is wait, what if she is? What if she has arranged all this as a ruse to draw you out? You're not wearing the armor gifted to you by Thor himself.
I know, but it is a risk I must take. As you know, Odin himself hung from the tree in order to gain knowledge of runes. I, too, must do this in order to gain knowledge of heavy explosives.
But my lord, I've heard you made many references to the fact that you have already been hung several times.
Yes.
Or was it that you were already hung? I can't remember.
Both of those are true. Some of the women I've been with have extremely thorough sex dungeons.
Thorough sex dungeons?
Sex dungeons? My lord, are you saying you are going to a dungeon?
I don't know. Is there like...
Einar is essentially...
Is this like a limousine where I can like put the privacy screen on?
If you want it to be, absolutely. Yeah.
There wasn't before, but then you reach and there's a button and it just goes... It's like in between the two of you.
So I imagine reason. Like there's just silence now.
You know what? I'm not going to press it. I'm just not going to say anything. I don't want to cut Einar off. I don't want to come and invest him.
So maybe
but
it's just
like,
a
are
scene.
Are you going to a dungeon? And I'm just like... No response.
Maybe it's a scene of like, you know, Einar, you're driving and you're looking at him in the revision mirror, and then his eyes just sort of like shift off and just look out the window or something like that, and it suddenly got very awkward, and maybe you like clear your throat a couple of times, but he doesn't react to it.
I'll be like, I must make sure to ask Heimdall. He was looking at those pictures of men and women together, and perhaps he understands the alchemy of the joining of the sexes. It seems that Lord Helsin does, but he doesn't wish to speak of it to me.
Oh, did you just imply out loud that you have never had sex?
I mean, is the divider up between us now?
No, it's not.
Oh. I thought, yeah. But yes, that's exactly what he's implying.
What?
Not only has he never had sex, he has no idea how it even happens. You have to remember, he grew up like a refugee, and he killed his
father. I know. Like, listen, I need you to update my schedule for tomorrow. You and I are going to have the talk. I need you to arrange for myself and Band, but not Barash and Zephyr, clear our schedules for the entire night.
You, I'm just going to turn and look at the dashboard and be like, spirit within the computer, new message. Tomorrow, we will be talking with Lord Helsin. The radio is just like on like like lowest volume setting. Like, do not speak back to me. Tomorrow, new meeting. It is done, Lord Helsin.
I call Band.
Band, you start getting a call.
Yeah, yeah.
What is your ringtone?
It's
specific
like
specific one for Dante.
Yeah, it's an alarm. That's the ball, summoner. 1 second. Hey, what is it?
Go into the computer, clear my schedule for tomorrow. Apparently, tomorrow evening. I have a lot to do tomorrow. Tomorrow evening, clear your own schedule as well. You are going to convalesce with myself and Einar. He has never had sex, so we are going to take him to a premier strip club and then probably hire him a prostitute to teach him
he's
about the bird.
Kill everyone.
He's going to kill... Wait, you're not there.
Why don't we just hook him up with a nice girl, you know, send him on a couple dates. Old-fashioned style. He's an old-fashioned guy. I'd imagine he'd like to, yeah, go on like a boat trip or something with the lady.
How old is Einar?
I appreciate your thoughts on this matter. However, I think we'll refer to exactly what I said.
Right,
unless
you're the boss.
I'd rather not go to the strip club and get drunk on $30 steaks and gigantic bottles
get
of
drunk.
Red.
I love getting drunk on steaks every fucking time I get.
Just like a meat coma. It's like, oh.
Just put it into a blender, put it in like a fucking Vitamix.
Mr. Band, if you don't want to attend, just tell me.
Like, look, I've already got reservations for us at the nicest strip club in town.
Excellent, thank you so much. And afterwards, after he is no longer a virgin, because, again, remember that I'm the shittiest individual in the world, and this is perfectly okay for me to do, only in this fantasy world,
It's like, disclaimers.
After we've made him not a virgin, which is clearly not an okay thing, we're going to definitely... You can talk to him about finding a nice girl and going on dates and whatever. I'm not really sure how all that works, actually.
Well, maybe you should hang out, you know? We'll, you know, just chat it out. I've had a couple girlfriends.
You're about to have a nice girl.
Yes, I'm sure you have.
All right. And with
Look, I met two of them in person.
And with that...
Thank you so much for your assistance. Make sure you definitely... Just clear my next morning as well. It seems like we're going to get this
stuff. So maybe on the backside of your like arm or something like that, or maybe you, inside like your data or something like that, you have a picture which is clearly photoshopped of some girl. And it's like, it's literally a scan.
No, it's bigger from Archer. You've got the Japanese hollow girl, right?
Yeah, he's into 2D, you know. Anyway, let's...
Her name is Synergy.
Synergy. So maybe before the break ends, we just, like, see the car, like, sort of, like, pull up to, like, the... pull up to the clinic, and our fated heroes get out of the car. So, guys, we're going to take a 3 to 5 minute break. Got some genitals to rub together. Arthur, Dante Fierro is outside a clinic right now. It is pretty much it looks exactly like a clinic would. 100% the same. You see people coming and going, much like you would normally.
Clinic.
Yeah, it's actually a clinic. This is. Just outside the Night City combat zone. Oh, it's in one of the back here. Sorry. It's in one of the back parts of Night City. What are you doing?
I'm going directly inside, of course.
Okay.
Of course.
So inside, you see the usual, you know, people coughing, like, you know, and maybe there's a guy there with like some sort of like bloody shoulder wound, and he's just sort of holding it with like a bunch of like fucking toilet paper or something like that, and he's just like, ugh. And then there's like, you know, some like a bunch of old people just being like. But the doctor said that I had to take the pill inside of my bottom. And, you know, stuff like that, you know. So there is a front desk, like a reception. And there is a line there. So. What was that?
I think you and I go to very different clinics if there's someone asking for the... What do they call the suppository?
Yeah.
If there's someone that's like, yeah, well, I have to have a suppository.
The doctor said that it's something that I need to put inside of my bottom, but I can't reach it all the way around. I was wondering if you might be able to have one of the nurses put it in there for me.
You know, just shit like that.
I have a feeling that this has happened to Dave. Like, he's been in the area.
Mate, I don't make it a habit of going to fucking hospitals, alright? I imagine, like, old people just being like, I'm just so lonely, I want to talk to someone. Like, you know, get on down to the clinic,
the nice
talk
part
about
this being on the internet is in 30 years, Dave can look back at it and be like, I've become that person now.
In 30 years' time, Arthur, I'd imagine that I would remove myself from humanity in total, and my only human interaction that I would have would be through my streaming, because I would still be streaming. It's like, welcome everybody to Die Party. I'm 85 years old. And I'm still rolling them hot die.
You just get all... It's like,
oh, God.
What is that book? where he just gets air delivery food every day so he can keep playing video games 24/7.
That
Ready
sounds
Player
great.
One. Yeah, you're going to be Ready Player One-ing.
Nice. No, I'd probably still cook, maybe. Anyway, so what do you do? The reception is kind of busy right now with this old person talking about
I literally skip past reception.
You just, like palm her out of the way. It's like, yeah.
I literally just push space.
Oh, my gosh.
It's the Assassin's Creed pushing, but instead of, like,
swimming through
back,
people,
it just faces.
Dave, I'm really their faces, just like, excuse me.
I'm really a 24 stealth check to remain incognito and follow him through the clinic. In my giant, like, draped with weaponry, covered in my assault armor, just like, I have a newspaper, and I'm just like opening the newspaper whenever he turns around to look at me. Like,
so this
you look
is
like every gangbanger in the place, right?
Yeah. So this isn't like so much like you're hidden from view. It's just more like no one cares.
Oh, no, I'm not talking about, like, anybody else. I just want to remain hidden from Lord Helsen.
He's got a newspaper.
I have a newspaper, and, like, whenever he turns, he's like, boom, pop the newspaper open.
Oh, yeah, man.
You probably know that I like looking at newspapers and just being like, ah, the front page.
Like, standing, reading the other side of the newspaper.
I just happen to like print media, and I support it in every way.
Yeah. So yeah, tell me like, so basically you palm through all these people. You palm your way through all the people there, and at the desk there's like a young girl, young black girl, and she's just like, yes.
Yes, I'm looking for Tabitha.
So she's, like, got really long nails, like, really long nails, like, to the point where she's, like, that's what she's doing all day, just sort of, like, maintaining her really long nails. And she's just, like, she leans forward without really looking, and she presses a button, and she goes, Tabitha, there's a handsome man here to see you.
I just keep walking past her and go to Tabitha.
You get to a door, and it, like, it's sort of, like, locked. And you shake it a little bit, and then you hear like a bing, like a buzz, and then you can open it and walk through. So
that's good. I didn't want to have to call Ben. Be like, hack this door for me.
I'm trying to get in to have some intercourse. Would you open this door for me, Ben? It's like, okay. Oh boy, how to describe this? So, ladies and gentlemen, Tabitha's hotness scale was literally a fumble.
Can it please be more than that?
Alright, so basically, maybe it's Arthur, you see, like, the back. Like, you see Tabitha's office. Like, you know, Tabitha, what was her last name?
Huh?
What's Tabitha's last name?
Yeah, give me a second, I got it.
Glasscock.
Stone.
Tabitha Stone.
Her last name is Stone.
Okay, so you see the office for Tabitha Stone, and maybe you walk in, and she's like, got her back to you, and she's like, Mr. Dante, please have a seat and take off your pants.
Oh, shit.
Then she sort of turns around, and Arthur, can you elaborate for me what would be, like, someone who is the exact opposite of what you would want in a female?
I don't think so.
Or what Dante's exact opposite would be?
Can we leave it to the viewers to each pick their own image?
What
they believe this woman looks like.
So what race is Tabitha, just out of curiosity? Saren.
Why do you have to bring race into this?
She's what, Asian?
It's Caucasian.
Caucasian. So yeah, she turns around. She's
she was gonna be Asian originally, but then we just decided to throw another cock in there.
Yeah.
She just saw the cock.
So she's deathly pale, right? She's deathly pale to the point where maybe she doesn't get out a lot in the clinic, and she's got, like, just a little bit of a mustache going on. Just a little bit.
She basically looks like Band Morda, is what you're saying.
Oh.
She has black hair, and maybe it's just sort of like got that little bit of like, I haven't washed my hair in like a month and a half sort of look to it, where it's a little bit greasy, you know. And
my God.
And
it's just sticking up away from her face.
Yeah, and it's just like, you know, the look of someone who's literally just come off a 12-hour shift that doesn't maybe care about hygiene too much. And she sort of, like, smiles, and you can hear the sound effect of a smile again. It's like, you know, like that, as she smiles as you walk into the room.
Her lips are so dry you can hear the saliva peeling away.
What was that, Arthur?
You must be around some strange people when they smile.
I'm just trying
No. I know exactly what he's talking about. I know people like that.
Mm-hmm.
When people's mouths are like glued shut with their own saliva, and then they open, it's like peeling away.
Hmm.
Oh yeah.
Oh God, it's the worst.
So
that was some of the best description I've ever heard, Henley. That's
thank
amazing.
You. Yeah. Oh, I mean, she's like, if she If she took care of herself a lot more, she would probably be on the scale of a 1 to 10, probably like a 6 or a 7. But she just doesn't care. Like, she's gotten to the point where her work is her priority, and her personal attractiveness has suffered so much. So, you know, she's a fixer-upper, Arthur. There you go.
Something to make her a better woman, please.
Yeah. So, what do you do, Arthur? She sort of invited you in, told you to take off your pants. What do you do?
I do exactly that.
So you just sort of walk in, shut the door, and then, like, maybe the door shuts, we just hear the pants, your belt buckle hit the floor or something.
At least he's in, like, a doctor's office, and she's a doctor. He can just pretend that this is just what the doctor's asking him to do, and he acquiesces.
Your pants. Turn your head to the right.
And cough for me, Mr. Dante Fierro. So let's take a look. Now, the Mr. Stud does something something particular, doesn't it?
No. It's very vague what Mr. Stud does.
Yeah,
it's
very vague. Do you want to read it out for everyone?
He
I think it just says she'll never know.
She'll never know. Okay. Let's take a look here.
I literally haven't checked for like 15 years since the last time I did this. But I'm fairly certain they do not actually describe what the Mr. Stud
does. Yeah, I think you might be right, but I'm going to take a look here anyway because it's funny. It's funny.
I think we should be able to, like, you know, it's, how much did it cost? It obviously has a different vibrating really settings. It's got to have, like, variable length and
girth. You're saying these things, but that's all just pre-built into Dante as God.
Dante has a vibrating setting, yeah.
He has a vibrating penis with variable length and girth. That's pretty impressive.
Yeah,
pretty
impressive. He's a very impressive man, of course.
I need a tissue.
Welcome to Cyberpunk, where Mr. Stud sexual excited. Implant.
No!
Let me read this out for everyone.
All right.
All night, every night, she'll never know. Use your imagination and add a +1 to your seduction checks. Also available in the Midnight Lady version for the distaff side. There you go. So that's what that is.
That's what you bought.
That's what
you
bought.
Saw
that,
and you bought it right away.
And you've got a contraceptive implant. Yes. Implanted underneath the left arm. It prevents pregnancy for up to 5 years.
Really, you're going to say this part in
a available
sexy.
For both sexes.
So, can we actually have a check on how long it's been since he got it?
4 hours.
Okay. I got it before I came here.
I get it checked every like year.
So basically
Dante ain't gonna paternity suit.
He's not
about that life.
Dante ain't no baby daddy.
So this is actually an important role because
no baby daddies.
We need to work out exactly how well you do. So, did you add the +1 to your seduction already?
Nope.
All right. So you want to add that because that's just an inherent +1. So you can just add that.
I don't think. I mean, so it doesn't count towards my IP if I want to improve it later.
No, it doesn't. But okay. So we just add it as
a
+1.
Yeah, I was just gonna add it.
I see. As needed. Okay. So.
You don't have any points in perform, so we'll just go with seduction.
That's not.
Yeah, I know. But...
No, that's not what that is.
Okay, so we're So she'll make a. Yeah, you make a seduction check for me, please.
So I want to describe this. Like, I've taken off my pants, and when she turns around, I immediately just stand up, and I'm just huge, like bear hug, weird kisses on her, just like make it as weird and awkward as possible.
Because it isn't already, right?
I rolled a 10 and then got another 2 on there. So.
Wow, okay. You know what? Add 2 more points in your seduction at people for that. That's impressive. So your wet kisses are exactly what Tabitha needed.
I knew it. I knew it all along.
So,
girl freak.
Yeah, I mean, I'm not going to describe it because, you know, it gets into the mummy porn territory a little bit.
Really?
Okay, do you want me to? All right, you're
not fucking described. No, it's fine, Dave. It's fine.
Your Mr. Stud implant rubs caresses her thigh.
To continue, Dave. I don't think that was his argument.
Yeah, so...
Make him do it.
The Mr. Stud implant of Dante Fierro rubs seductively against the inner thigh of Tabitha.
Tabitha, come on, you usually do sound effects.
Mr. Dante! I've never met anyone so impressive. And Dante's just like, well, I do pay someone to enhance my intelligence. Yeah, so, you know, that's pretty much, you know. Einar, you're basically reading this paper. You've been reading this paper.
I imagine at this point I poked holes in it with my knife.
Yeah.
So I can look through it, like, as I'm spying on him.
So maybe you're sitting, like, in between two old people.
Mm-hmm.
And you're just this fucking mountain of, like, like, shit right now. And you're just, like, reading this paper that's, like... You know how papers are, like, this big? Compared to you, mm-hmm. it's, like... You have your elbows are like outside.
It's like a paperback novel in
My hands. Yeah. Basically. And you're just like flipping through this paper and the old man's next to you is like, ah, you're done with the sports section, Sonny.
These symbols are strange and foreign to me. Perhaps you could help me, old man. I'm just staring at a page I cannot read this entire time.
So the old man's like, oh, you can't read. Very well. Let me help you. That one there is an A.
I do not understand sorcery. I was like, throw the paper down.
No one pays attention to you except for the old man. It's like, and then he leans down. He's like, that one there is a C. So this goes on for a while, unless you want to do something in particular.
No, I'll stay like growing more and more impatient, as I'm not entirely certain why Lord Helson is here in the first place.
Mm-hmm.
And in fact, I'm gonna get out my phone. I'm gonna call. Freya. I'm gonna call her up.
Hello.
Freya. We are here at the place where you mend broken warriors and piece them back together before sending them on.
Lord Helson.
Hi. Lord Helson is speaking with your
Tabitha. I don't know what to call it. Her name is Tabitha.
Tabitha?
Yeah, Tabitha.
Tabitha.
I have been here for many minutes, and he has been in there making strange noises this entire time.
Yes, he's in the middle of a ritual, a very important ritual that will get him much information.
He is hanging from the tree of knowledge, then, as he said.
Oh, he is currently hanging suspended from something,
from
Yggdrasil's
boughs. I see.
Yes. Just give him some time and he'll be fine.
Very well. There are many criminals and miscreants, those whose souls we can harvest for Valhalla.
Oh.
I'm speaking at this tone of voice as well. Just please, like shouting across the room.
Please do me a favor and don't harvest any of those souls, okay? Because we kind of need to save them for the streets.
Are they to be warriors in the
in this land? Yes, in this land. They are to be warriors in this land. Not quite in Valhalla yet. They're not ready. They still have heard, to prove themselves.
I have heard, Lord... I have heard Lord Helsin invoking the names of several gods from inside this room. I am not certain if he requires my aid.
So, are we going with the canon that that either you or Tabitha is extremely loud?
Oh yeah.
Which one? Both of you or just one of you?
It's both.
Both? Okay.
It's not so much like, oh god, it's like, oh god.
No. Let's be clear here. I'm in.
Dante's like, oh god. Tabitha's like, oh god.
Entire life right now. Everything after this is going to feel like...
You're very hard to hear right now, Arthur.
Yeah.
What?
Yeah, you're breaking up.
You're breaking up, yeah. I think it might be your microphone.
Did you say I need another microphone?
Okay, you're good now.
Yeah, we need
one. Okay,
yeah.
This microphone just got a little bit excited there and it was really hard to hear.
Yeah.
So, yeah. I'm here. I'm committed to this. I'm into it. It's literally going to be the greatest night of her life. Greatest possible moment of her entire life. Everything after this is just downhill.
So, Arthur, I want to run this past you, right? I would like to make a seduction check against you to see whether or not you fall in love with this girl. Are you okay with that?
Oh, no!
Not really. Not okay with it. No. Dante's not a lover, right?
Like, what about maybe you just kind of dig her a little bit?
Yeah.
I mean, the thing is...
Like, I want her to be a main squeeze for you.
My thought is that I would just literally be like, listen, you need wardrobe help, and I can design clothing.
Okay.
Call me again.
Okay.
I'm going to, like Dante always does, completely abuse this relationship. So anytime I need to get Zephyr out of work, I'm just going to be like, all right, let's do this.
Yeah, okay.
Anytime I need drugs or guns, just be like, hey, what's up, girl? Give me... Yeah, I'm... down with it.
Give me a social check real quickly.
Oh my god.
Which one? Or is there actually a check that's just called social?
Yeah, there is a check called social, yeah.
I might not have it a lot be, of points
it
in that.
It should be...
That's
should
literally
be
a... the best skill that I have.
Oh, well that's good, because it's a career skill for you, so... Alright, yeah, that's pretty much what you needed. So, you know, maybe like post-coitus... You know, you're both sitting on the floor, covered in, like, the sheet that goes on, like...
The exam bed. Table sheets.
Yeah, the exam table sheets or whatever, you know? Because it's an M...
You've
pulled
down it's
an R-rated... Okay, so it's an MA-15 plus movie or TV show in America, but they still don't show boob, right? So let's be real. Okay. So it's tasteful side boob or top boob, whatever you want to go with.
I like underboob. It's my favorite.
Well, it's a little hard with the sheet, but...
God, you guys are
funny. But, you know, maybe it's one of those things where, like, you sort of get talking about, like, all the stuff that she is, like, missing by working so much, and, you know, maybe you see an in here correct what's wrong in her life and maybe make her like an actual contact if you wanted to.
Yeah, you sound like you're trying to get me to fix this woman. The only thing I'm willing to
no
fix
you don't
is
have to
personal hygiene and grooming.
Yeah, no, that's all you can, that's if you want, that's all.
Yeah,
it needs to
I'm
be,
just gonna be like, you know, Tabitha, we spent some time together. I happen to be a pretty amazing hairstylist and fashion.
I've
perhaps
noticed.
You should give me a call sometime, and we'll work on your look, and we can help you be you.
You know what? I haven't had a spa day in a very long time.
You know what? I was just saying to Zephyr that she also needed the spa day.
Oh, fuck
I will
you.
Definitely hook the two of you up with the spa day, and at the end of it, we can go clothes shopping, and
Dante,
we can definitely have some personal grooming lessons. Zephyr can talk to from that as well.
And she sort of like perks up at this and she's like, I'm going to have to thank Tabitha after this. You have been just
she
the
is Tabitha.
Best.
She is Tabitha.
Wait, Zephyr, I'm going to have
I'm
to
not
thank
there.
I'm going to have to thank Takahara after this because you have just been the best. Where have you been my whole life, Dante?
Working.
Yeah,
me speaking too. Of, I need to get back to it.
Oh, tell Takahara, and maybe she's like, you know, putting on her clothing again while she's saying this, and he's like, tell Takahara whatever she wanted. It's hers. I've never been this elated in a very long time.
I think I'll just look at my watch and just be like, that's kind of how it goes for me all the time. It's like, yeah, I hear that all the time. So I'm just like, yep, this is normal.
Yeah. Right. Yeah, okay, great.
Before this happens,
yeah.
I want to make a streetwise check to try to pick up some random drugs from literally anyone in the clinic.
Random?
Like, what? Just directly shit? Going to people like, do you have any substance that would alter my state of consciousness?
I'm literally going to walk out and just dying. Be like, Ina, you're coming with me right now. No more drugs for you. You've disobeyed my
look,
orders.
Look, he got what he needed. Ina's going
to
get hit.
He caught you in the clinic. You were supposed to be in the car.
I am extremely disappointed in you right now, Ina. You know if you need to get drugs, you don't do it publicly. You contact Takahara.
He says out loud in the clinic she works at.
Yeah.
It's okay. They're good. They all know.
I heard frightful noises coming from within the room, Lord Helson. I could not in good conscience stay out in the car.
Everything is fine.
It sounded dangerous.
It is dangerous. You'll learn more tomorrow night, my friend.
Imagine when they take him out and they hear those noises. He's going to be so scared.
I know. It's time to take me home.
Oh,
of course, Lord Helson. I'm gonna like be like feeling him over for wounds while he's like walking out of the clinic. Just like,
oh,
are you hurt, my lord?
Nope, I am perfectly all right.
Maybe a little.
I'm
bruised.
Really uncomfortable with you touching me right now. You know
you're
that
so
I have a very minimal
my lord,
touching
you're,
policy.
You're drenched in sweat and you smell awful.
Well, I mean, I
smell
sure
like the market.
I'm sure that I don't smell awful, but. I suppose I could be. Anyway, I need to take a shower when I get back.
Okay, I'm gonna give
it. There's wafting scent coming from your groin, my lord.
Exactly.
Oh, come on, shipping it. Come on.
It reminds me of the days when I was on the sea. Fishes,
oh, it,
great fishes.
It smells like the musk oxen in spring.
Let me tell you a story about me old bone.
Oh my god.
Wow, guys. Wow. Okay.
I don't
want to
play
all
a
right.
crazy character now.
Really, Dave, you're
lies.
The one who started this.
Hey man, I don't build the rabbit hole. I let it fall where it goes. All right.
Literally built the rabbit hole.
You're the one that introduced yourself with "check out my penis" at my website, DanteFierro.penis.com.
Go to DanteBonus.com. Check out my penis. That's
true, but... Oh no, Dave created the rabbit hole. The AP was the one who dived right into it.
Anyway, so.
Oh shit.
So, yeah, anyway, what is everyone else doing? Or maybe we can just skip straight.
I am making a bot, but I'm making that bot
oh, yeah,
to
yeah,
harass
absolutely.
Samantha.
So,
Dallas.
I've thought about this. This is going to be a two-part role. The first one is a library search to find out, you know, her aliases, where she hangs out online and that sort of stuff. The second one is a programming to work to create the actual bot that will, like, literally haunt her ass online, so...
Okay, so here's the library search.
Yeah. The higher, the better. Okay, 16, yep, you're good for that. You basically find... Like, Dante, this is your sort of backstory character.
Yeah.
Where do you imagine she would hang out online? Now, what type of places?
Pinterest, Etsy...
like, does she
however,
make her...
Like,
yeah, she's a toy maker, make, right? So maybe she's
definitely
yeah.
on
yeah,
Tumblr.
I'll
feel
make
like Samantha's on Tumblr.
Makes fake requests for, like,
purchases
commissions.
And stuff. Yeah, like, yeah. Like she'll spend, like, all of her time, like, making shit, and then she'll never get paid for it. Oh, God, that's awful.
She's a moderator on at least 4 Sex in the City fan sites.
Oh, my God.
She has her own WordPress blog. About her
yeah.
autograph.
I'll make sure to like make sure that the bot is properly programmed to dislike the characters on the show that she does like and like, you know.
Just, and just give reasons why they're the worst like, characters
yeah.
to draw her
yeah.
into arguments.
Okay. Yeah. So the programming role will describe how intelligent this bot is that you're gonna make.
Okay, how good okay.
Listen, so just need 25 here. Just luck out.
Oh that crushed.
just the
so
best.
It's going to be like the Microsoft robot. Twitter robot.
Oh my fucking
oh my god.
It's now it's OE.
Best at my job.
Oh, you are all so right. good at this game.
So for people listening on the podcast, he literally rolled a 17 on a 1d10. So good job on that. And his total roll was that of a 30. So this is a pretty incredible roll. So you create this bot that's almost like an artificial intelligence. And you know what? I'm willing to allow you to have this as like a subservient like helper.
Okay.
Wait. You want this to be his like Tony Stark bot?
Yes.
Troll bot. Just
yes.
putting troll bot on yeah, the on my character sheet.
So what are you Those calling two, this thing? What are you calling like this? This will also be like when you plug in, it'll be there to help you with stuff. When it comes to like doing library searches and like you
it's,
know,
it's the find... Inferno.
So okay, the Inferno. So this.
You're naming your robot after me.
So make a mark somewhere next to this robot that it'll help you with library searches. That's what it does. It'll give you a +2 to library searches.
Excellent.
Yeah. So this will help you out quite a bit. And you know what? Put 2 points next to programming for IP, please.
I really want to make like a robot or find like a monkey brain, and I want to put that AI into it.
Oh no!
Okay, so yeah, the Inferno sort of like just pops into existence, and it's like,
"Hello, Master. I am the Inferno."
I'm like, right, beautiful. Okay, we've got you a nice skin here. You look amazing. All right, so here's your first target. Her name's Samantha. I really want you to concentrate on the Sex and the City bit, you know?
Oh, get right in it there. Appears that she does not like Mr. Big. Well, that means I love Mr. Big.
Oh, you're a beautiful thing.
Samantha.
I couldn't remember anyone else aside from Mr. Big in that show. Like, so that's what I wrote.
I will make perfect. Her regret her personal choice and character selection. Her life will be miserable. Inferno out.
And it like disappears from your like UI or whatever, and it's just like, yeah.
I feel like this is like the Shepard VI from Mass Effect 2, where it shows up and is like, I would have deleted those files, but I'm too busy saving the galaxy. Literally like Dante Inferno fan art right here.
Okay. All right. That I never expected you to make an AI this episode, so that's fantastic. Yeah. That's congrats. Never going to come back to haunt us. Never.
All
right. So
way, it down will. The line, it's going to be like Swan Song, where this thing just takes over my car.
So all of a sudden, like maybe if you're watching her like her Twitter account and her like Pinterest account, she suddenly gets like 3,000 more followers like over the next hour or so, and every single one of them is just like talking to her about things she's mentioned previously. And some of them might even be soliciting her for, like, you know, like, drugs, sex, like, penis enhancements. And then there's some in there that are just like, hey, I was wondering how I contact you about creating a toy that's, like, life-size figurine of, like, you know, my favorite character from, like, you know, Sex and the
City. My
little
pony.
And, you know, just shit like that. And it's like, I was wondering how heavy, like... you know, having a completely life-size replica of Mr. Big would cost, made entirely out of metal and wood.
Wow.
And just like, you know, shit like that. And, you know, it's just like, do you have a personal number that I can contact you on? And, you know, just like, just basic, your barrage of shit like that.
You're hot, show your boobs.
Yeah.
You're so good.
I don't believe you're a female.
I'm still jacked in, and I'm just, like, watching the handiwork. I have, like, a bunch of floating screens just, like you know, monitoring her situation. Just, like, laughing.
Yeah. All right. Barash, what are you building right now?
Well, hopefully it's... Did we actually get the warehouse as the big
entrance
no.
here? I mean, there is, like, you've found something. That's the other part of this. Like, you've found a sort of like a chop shop just outside of the Night City proper. Actually, no, it's really far outside of Night City proper. But it matches everything that you want. It's near, like, a power grid. It's got, like, a, you know, constant supply of water coming and going from it. It's off a main street, so it's, you know, you're not going to be, like, diverting traffic if something happens. So it's a nice place. It's exactly what you want. The problem is...
it doesn't have a breakfast nook.
That... And it dealer. Also doesn't have. It also happens to be currently occupied by a mechanic shop that, for the most part, doesn't have a lot of car traffic going away from it. If that makes any sense.
It does.
You see cars coming in, but you see no cars coming out. And, you know.
Sense duplicity here.
Mm-hmm.
Drug runners.
So yeah,
it's a chop shop. It's not drug runners. It's a chop shop.
So if you guys wanna, unless Takahara, you have something you want to do?
I'm still in the middle of. Well, no. So I'm waiting to find out what happened with Garrett because he's like, "Where are you right now?"
Oh, that's right.
I
yeah.
Sent that address.
Okay, so you send him the address, and yeah, no, he'll show up.
Shit.
Yeah, so he's you basically, like, you know, the little, what was your waiter called, or your little Jarvis guy called, Arthur?
Jarvis.
Remember you had, like, that sort of guy that'd be like, "Hello, sir, I am your..."
Oh, some nameless dude. I literally have, like, a dozen of those guys on staff.
Okay, I was like...
like the current one on staff, his name is,
Jordan.
Sure.
Jordan Twinbuckle.
Yeah, even better.
Is he a halfling? Sounds like a hobbit.
There actually are cybernetics that allow you to do that type of stuff.
No, nope, mm-hmm. We're done. Oh, yeah. We're not discussing that.
Yeah, so, okay, so what was his name?
Jordan Twinbuckle.
Jordan.
Yeah, Jordan Twinbuckle.
Okay, so, you get, there's a doorbell ringing right now. It's like,
No, my doorbell is the Game of Thrones theme.
You're such a nerd.
Why do all these people hang out in my fucking apartment anyway?
Because you made us live there.
I didn't make you live there. You people just didn't buy homes because you're poor hobo.
I have an apartment.
My dad kicked me out.
Well, go live there.
All right. So
Dan is the only one who doesn't have some place to live.
So you guys, Zephyr, you hear a doorbell ringing. What do you do? Well, what is supposedly the doorbell?
So I'm gonna go. Is there like a hallway? Can I go to the end of the hallway and watch your...
So Dante's on the penthouse. So basically, in order to go up, right, you have to
get into the elevator.
You first need to ring the doorbell on the ground floor.
They have to buzz you up.
And then you have to go through the elevator to get to there. The only entrance that he has is like an elevator. And then there's also like there is a fire escape. But, you know, it's covered by, like, maybe a bookcase or something like that, because it's fucking Dante's house, so...
That sounds reasonable. Yeah. I would just have Einar push it out of the way in an emergency.
Yeah.
So where's Jordan at? What's he doing?
Well, there's a doorbell ringing.
All right, so is Jordan going downstairs? Is he
letting
him up?
I mean, like, in a lot of cases, like... unless he's been invited in, he will ring the doorbell. So if you want to answer it, like if you want to answer the IP, you can.
Okay, so I go over to the panel.
Yeah.
Hello?
Madam, we have one Garrett here to see a Zephyr Takahara. Would she happen to be in right now?
I'm coming down.
Very well, I will have him wait in the lobby.
Alright, so I go into the elevator and I go down to the lobby.
Okay, Down there, you see Garrett and one other person.
Who is the other person?
I don't know.
Is it a male or female?
It is. Let me just check for you.
Okay, it's not Samantha.
Fuck you.
What if Garrett and Samantha teamed up?
Alright.
It's a little 10-year-old girl. I'm gonna die.
It is a female, and she is small, yes.
Yeah, I called it. Hello.
Hello.
So Garrett just sort of sits there, and he's just like, so, tell me about why you killed my contact.
I didn't do it. Garrett, I didn't do it.
You let it happen. I trusted you. I trusted you. You asked me to help you out. And what did you do? You killed my contact. You killed him. And then, like, the girl puts a hand on Garrett's chest and, like, pushes him and sits him down on, like, a bench or something like that.
Listen, and then, it wasn't my intention.
And then she puts up a finger and she's just like, She sort of, like, sits back and she sort of, like, takes a little bit of time to, like, take you in. Like, she sort of looks you up and down and she's just like, you do realize what you've done to us, right?
Us? So you guys are a thing now?
He just, like, quirks an eyebrow and looks over at Garrett and she's
maybe
like,
I, like, this is at the, safe house, right?
Yeah, but it's downstairs.
Yeah, but it's not down at the bottom.
Yeah, it's in the lobby. Yeah. And she's like, what we are doesn't concern you.
Of course not. Yes, because I am just a plebe to you, right? So anyhow, here's what happened. For whatever reason, my employer did not happen to take any cash with him, which would be the, you know, commerce that we would use on the streets. He thought he could just use a credit card. So, as it stands, he got made fun of, he got a little pissed off, and he blew him up because he's a crazy sociopath.
So Garrett will stand up and be like, but you put, and then the girl will, like, just sit him back down, and she's
yes,
like,
and I tried to tell him to go and get the cash for this gentleman, and do you want to know how much he listens to me? He listens to me a fucko, okay? He does not listen to me, because I am nothing to him except for a contact booster for his dumbass.
So she looks over at Garrett and she's like, so, what I understand is that you are throwing your employer under the bus in this instance?
I'm not throwing my employer under the bus, but I would say that he is a little bit testy when it comes to shit. Yes.
Interesting. Here's our demands. Or here's my demands. Let me be more specific
here. Both your demands. You know what? How about this? You go.
She, like, does the thing that everyone who's, like, in a Western does, where she, like, opens up, like, her jacket, and inside she's got, like, you know, an SMG.
Ow! You hear, like, an eagle fly by with a horrible screaming pierce. Yeah.
And she's like,
well, actually, there's something I want to... This is, like, the penthouse. There are probably security and guards and cameras monitoring.
No, this is in the lobby.
We're in the lobby.
But she does it slyly, like, where she, like, you know, how, like, a... You know, like, maybe, like, a cop will do that thing where he, like, has the gun on his belt and he sort of, like, exposes it a little bit just for the person in the conversation. So she's not, like, you know, pulling it out and being like, what's that motherfucker? She's not doing that. It's basically inside her jacket, but she's, like, sort of just, you know, opening up the jacket a little bit just to expose just to Takahara what she's carrying right now. And she's like, I don't care what...
You know what actually would be... Mm-hmm. It'd be really funny if in this instance, if you just see Barash walk in with Gogorilla behind him, he just waves in and Takahara then goes to the elevator and goes up.
So, yeah, she's just like, in this instance, you have very little that you can actually do. Here's our demands. Well, my demands. And you will listen.
What? I shouldn't listen to you. You're like 12 years old.
Garrett just sort of just goes, oh my god. And then she's just like,
if you don't, the one that we will murder will be you. Understand?
Yeah, I understand.
Okay, then. Shut your mouth and listen to me. Because there is only so much I'm willing to put up with.
But you do understand at this point, I have nothing to give you people.
Shut up and listen to me. I don't want to hear your moaning anymore. Here is what you need to replace. We had one hell of a contact. And your friend, or your employer, or whatever he is to you, lover, whatever, it doesn't matter, killed him.
Well, head lover, but you're fucking him now, so whatever.
He just looks up at you and he just, like, maybe, like, she doesn't turn around, but he's just sort of, like, just, like, doing that sort of thing, you know, just, like,
I, like, so full of laugh.
And then she goes,
you will replace our contact. I don't care who it is, as long as he can get what we need. In terms of your friend, Dante, was it? He will pay for what he's done.
He won't pay for shit. Don't you understand? That's what I was trying to tell you. He isn't going to pay for anything.
That's true. I'm going to murder the shit out of
you. He will kill you all, because that's what he does. He kills people. He kills people he doesn't even know for making fun of him for using a credit card. Do you think he's going to, like, stop at you, a 12-year-old fucking midget? Really? He isn't going to stop. You're silly. You're so silly. How about you take your ass outside the door and walk away from wherever it was you came from, and I'll take care of this. We'll find you guys another person. You know, Garrett, you can go have fun with your 12-year-old or whatever, and we'll settle this. It'll be fine. You'll be fine. We'll get you some more guns. Enjoy. Have a great night.
I'm going to turn. Yeah, the moment you turn, she will actually give me initiative real quickly.
Now, wait a second.
Fuck.
The doorman is still around here, right?
Yeah, he is.
And this is the reason I pay a shit ton of money is because this is a secure-ass facility. Is there any chance that this guy is basically just Einar 2.0? He just whips out a grenade launcher and guns them down right here? I pay a shit ton of money for this.
Yeah, no, place. I'm willing to let that happen, okay. But we're still going to roll an initiative check here.
All right.
So, let me just delete those real quick. All right. So, what is your initiative?
Not very high.
Okay.
Chat's making me Eddie Murphy laugh.
That was literally some of the best, like, ex-girlfriend drama I've ever heard live on stream. Like, maybe the ex.
All right.
Like, why don't you take your 12-year-old fucking new lover?
Get the fuck out of here, bitches!
Exactly. I could see the head bobble and the finger going, like, oh yeah. It was perfect.
Wow.
It's funny because I'm like, oh man, so funny. Whatever.
Yeah.
I'm gonna get fucking
Jordan kills right. These fucking people, that is gonna solve so many problems.
So she basically, like, you know, you ever do the thing where you kick someone's back of the kneecap? And then, like, it drops down on the floor. So she does that. She fucking just, like, fucking legs you. And then you fall to the ground and she grabs you around, like, the throat here. So what we're going to do is I'm going to make you make a martial arts defense here with a -5 because, you know, it's from your behind and you did not expect it. So let's go. So do you have anything brawling, martial arts, anything like that?
I ain't got none of that shit.
Okay.
I don't have none of that.
Yeah, but she has, like, she's like medicinal knowledge of, like, where to hit someone to make them hurt.
Yeah, that doesn't help. Yeah, so do you have anything in martial arts, any of them, fencing, melee, dodge, or athletics?
No.
Okay, so you will need to roll a reflex plus 1d10.
And I have like a 3 in reflex.
Okay, let's take a look what she's got. Ooh.
Did go?
You got 6. A 6, okay.
And I need a 1... Did you say any 1d10, though?
No, that's it. You rolled it, right?
Okay, that's fine. Okay.
So you got a 3 plus a 3. 1d10 plus... 5 plus 3. Yeah, okay. Yeah, so she knocks you down to the ground and gets you in a grapple, and then she's, like, maybe, like, behind the desk. What did you say his name was, Arthur?
Jordan... Windbuckle.
All right, so Jordan pulls out this a heavy pistol, and he's like pointing it at them, and he's like, "M'lady, would you need me to help you out in this instance?"
M'lady, shall I blow them away by popping a cap into their ass?
Proverbial asses. Takahara.
What's that?
Don thy body armor, young one, for I will duel thee mightily.
Would you like me to make the shot, m'lady, and free you from the hands of this captive?
I would not. You know what? Just get her off of me.
All
right. I have more pressing issues that I have to deal with, mostly taking care of Dante and making sure that he has his contacts that he needs. Just make sure these people are escorted outside of the building, please, and make sure they never come back.
So you're saying this while she's got, like, a fucking knife to your throat sort of thing?
Yeah.
And she's just like, "You better respect me, you little bitch."
I'm not gonna fucking respect the 12-year-old!
So she, like, puts the knife closer to your neck. Give me a cool check. Give me a cool check, please.
Alright.
And you need, like, a 15 or higher.
Cool's pretty fucking high.
There you go. Yeah, so you're not worried right now.
Yeah, so I'm, like, looking at her like, really, bitch, if you're gonna fucking kill me, then fucking kill me. Because, really, at this moment, I am a slave to a fucking corporate being, and my boyfriend's fucking a 12-year-old. So come on, bitch, fuck with me right now.
She's like, "Stop calling me a fucking 12-year-old. I'm 23 years old.
So get the fuck out of here before this motherfucker caps a cap in your ass."
So she will grab your hair. How long is your hair right now?
It's really short.
All right, she'll grab it and just... fucking pull it as hard as she can.
Please be a baby.
Can you give me a 1d10 plus your reflex real quick? This is for melee defense. Yeah,
my reflex is a 3, so it's a 1d10 plus 3.
Yeah, 1d10 plus 3. Just go. Just roll reflex. That's all you need to do. So just click that all reflex right. button.
Oh my god.
23 years old.
Not 12, I swear!
She's just stamping her foot like, "I'm 23, I'm your supervisor."
So yeah, she like pulls you, she basically turns you around and like pulls your hair. And it's like, "Yeah, bitch, well, can a fucking 23-year-old who looks like a 12-year-old do this?" And then she like fucking karate chops you in the neck.
the straight up judo chop.
Yeah, just like, yeah. She grabs you by the hair and just goes fucking whack, like straight in the neck.
Woo! And then it's like chop. Open head chops you across the chest.
So let's see. 1d6. D6 plus 2. Alright, so what is your body right now? And do you have any armor around your neck?
I have...
What do you have, like chest or head? Like what are you rolling with?
Okay, so my body is a 5, and then I have on my head the 20.
Your body is a... What do you got on your head?
I've got nylon helmet.
Okay, that won't help you. What is your body right now?
5.
All right, so what is the BTM score on a 5? Did you write that in for your character?
It currently says 0, so no, I didn't write it in.
It might be 0, because mine is -2 right now.
For BTM?
Well, I didn't write it in.
I think it auto calculates.
No, it doesn't.
Try
No? Okay, so for 5, it's -2. So
okay,
you take
so -2.
So you take 4 damage.
All right. So what am I at? So 1, 2, 3, and then I have what, serious 1?
Wait. How much damage have you taken previously? I thought you took none.
Like 1.
So you just add 2 more boxes on. Yeah, 4.
Okay.
So whatever that is. So.
So then,
but
like,
this, I'll
like
I'll be
three.
Willing to make this temporary since he's just karate chopping you basically. So.
All right.
Yeah. So it's your turn. What would you like to do? Remember, you're in a grapple right now, and she just fucking melee'd you in the neck.
Any fucking shit I can do? I'm in a fucking grapple. What the fuck am I gonna do?
Just
I'm like,
Jordan, blow him away. Just let him.
Pull
let
your
the
pistol.
Dog off of the leash.
Yeah.
I don't have to
jam it into her crotch and empty the magazine.
He sounds, you know, civilized, but he just wants them dead.
Alright, so I'm just gonna be like, Gary, get your bitch off of me, because I don't have time for this.
Okay. Yeah, okay, make a, since this is Garrett, what do you got social-wise? Do you have any empathy skills?
Yes, I have seduction, and that's it. Oh, and the human perception.
Are you gonna try and seduce him into doing this? Like, what are you trying to roll with here? Because you need to make a roll to make him do this, so... And you can't make a roll unless you have the skill, so...
Right. The only thing I have is seduction that could work on it. Everything else is zero.
So you're going to do the puppy dog eyes? Is that what's happening?
Yeah.
Okay.
Sure.
All right, give me a seduction. Okay. Yeah, no, that's good. So he'll just sort of, like, grab this girl who you don't have the name of yet and sort of just pull off and she'd be like...
Whole bag.
Can her name be Stacy? Wasn't that the name we used in all the...
There's like 3 Stacys.
No, her name...
What was the one that we used?
So he'll like pull her... Yeah, Becky. So he'll like pull off and she's like, Rhonda, no, come on.
Rhonda.
Yeah, and
her name was Becky, now it's Rhonda.
So maybe, because she's like so small, he's like picking her up by the waist, she's like fucking clawing at you. She's like, no, let me kill that bitch! It's like... This fucking like just being dragged out, and then like maybe God, I forget his name, like Buckle, whatever his name
Jordan,
is.
Jordan
Twin Buckle.
Gordon. Okay.
Twin Buckle.
So Jordan will sort of walk up like, you know, like cop style with his gun out, and he'll just like put you behind him, sort of thing, and then she'll like maybe like. Rhonda will like break off from like the grab and she'll like run at you, but then Garrett will like chase after her and grab her and pull her out, sort of thing. She's just like screaming, he's like, I'll kill that bitch! And it's like, yeah, so maybe like you're like choking on like for breath because she fucking nailed you in the throat with a karate chop or something like that. And she's like, Jordan is like, are you okay, m'lady? Would you like me to escort you to the first aid room?
No, I'll be fine. I just need to go upstairs and rest a bit. I'll be fine.
Very well. If they come back, what would you like me to do?
Shoot the shit out of them, please.
Very well.
So I head up to the elevator. I hit the button for the penthouse. I get in the elevator and go upstairs. I'm, like, rubbing my neck because it's, like, starting to bruise. I'm like, oh, fuck. There's going to be so many questions when they get back.
Speaking about questions, how about we take another break, guys?
Yay!
That was a terrible segue.
I guess the group is back together now. What are you guys doing? What's the fun thing that you guys are gonna be doing now?
I'm just like laughing. I unhook from my deck. This is probably like when.
So maybe you're winded from laughing so much because you're just like oh,
it's like a 10,000 13-year-olds all attacking her at once. It's hilarious.
Ben, shut up. don't say anything. Oh. If Einar finds out, he's going to go and murder everybody. And I'm, like, over there trying to, like, use concealer to cover up the bruises on my neck.
What are you talking about? I'm, like, unjacking from the
fucking
the
teenager's like, triggers you... Game of Siren now. Like,
yeah. Like, what are you talking about?
And then I walk out and look at her. As I'm, like, puffing a cigarette, and I'm just like, what happened to Chist and Nick and stuff?
I'm fine. Fuck off. And I'm like,
don't look fine. I know, doctor. Fine. That's not fine, though.
I'm fine. I'm okay.
I know, doctor. You, doctor. You should know this. That's not fine.
I'll be fine. Just keep Einar away from me for a while. Otherwise, things are going to get real.
And then, like, Einar walks in the door. I'm like, yeah. Einar, you see this? She bruised.
Do we walk in?
Yeah, you're all back at this point.
I'll be like, no, I apologize, Lord Helsing. I did not mean to say you smelled bad. It's simply you smelled like a farm animal during the springtime after the long winter.
I pull my collar up on my shirt so he can't see anything, and I walk away.
Yeah.
Into the kitchen.
So, trying to hide.
Let me roll my awareness notice check.
Fuck.
Oh, yeah. Crashed.
Oh, fuck, fuck.
I love how he's like, let me roll the one skill I have that I can get a 42 on.
Yes, precisely.
No, this will be human perception, not awareness.
Okay. Yeah,
Okay, whatever.
give me a stealth check, Game of Siren, if you have it.
Roll 20 says, no date.
I think I'm willing to take a negative on this day. Like, I am so contrite with Dante right now, like, focusing on him and, like, trying to apologize.
Yeah, even if you took a negative, you'd still get a 21, because at most, a negative 5 is what you get. Like, there's no, like, I'm gonna give you a negative 16.
I'll take a negative 5.
Where's it at?
It's like the very bottom under pilot.
It's in the reflex, not reflex. It's in it's under pilot.
I don't know why, like this the
pilot. Why the fuck is it under pilot?
Like, I don't know. Like, yeah. The ordering is sometimes odd in the sheet. Like, okay, yeah. You notice that she's covering something up, but you don't notice what. I'll say.
Oh, I'm not
going
to give a shit. I don't know. She's she is Lady Freya. I'm not going to question her motives.
Okay.
Just looking at her, she's like holding her fucking like. Like neck shrugged up, like
maybe she used to be a little bit of cleavage, sort of like button up shirt, but now she's like buttoned up to the neck, sort of thing. Like that's about all that's different, really.
I'll give it like just a glance, like not even I don't even give a shit. Give a glance and then go back. Like Lord Helsing, I spoke with the doorman. He said there was some sort of confrontation in the floor. Do you think it was Samantha?
I don't think it was Samantha.
So I'm gonna be like. You spoke to the doorman and there was a confrontation and you brought me up to my apartment without checking first.
Lord Helsing, he said specifically no one entered the apartment aside from the Lady Freya and Broker.
I'm literally like stepping into my Metal Gear.
Yeah.
Hey,
Paranoia
Dante, you might want to be careful for a little while. Just saying. Just be careful for a little while. Don't change out of your armor.
Lady, or Lord Helsing, Lady Freya.
Is there something you need to tell me?
Everything's cool. No, we're good. Just don't change out of your armor. You're good.
Maybe shower before
you
do that.
I demand you tell me immediately what it is you're attempting to hide.
I would like to see you in private then, Dante.
Yeah, I guess. I de-escalate from my armor again, because I still... you know what? I remember, I gotta take a shower. But now you're like, we gotta
join me in the shower. We will have the conversation there.
Oh, yeah. God damn it.
Yeah, yeah.
She's sitting on the toilet in the bathroom.
Outside my bathroom, and I will be in the shower, and we can have this conversation.
Okay.
I guess, whatever, man. I don't even know what to do anymore.
Yelling to him? Like,
no, yeah. I'm like... No, because it's not gonna be too loud. So I'm like, okay, so,
You know, you can come into the bathroom if you'd like.
I'll just talk through the door.
Are you sure?
Yeah, I'm sure.
Lady Freya can see through the mists of time, Lord Helsing. I doubt the mists of the shower will inhibit her very
much.
That's
true. Anyway, there's something I need to tell you. We're going to be taking Band and Einar out tomorrow night to a strip club. Apparently, Einar has never had sex, so we're going to introduce him to that concept.
Lord Helsing, is this strip club when you take apart weapons quickly? I am very good at this.
Your weapon will be taken apart, I assure you.
So how many people are in the bathroom right now when you're showering?
That's what I'm saying.
I feel like right now it's just me in the bathroom, but everybody's like standing outside.
Close around the hallway outside. Yeah.
Maybe the only bathroom in the place is like your ensuite, because you know. Well, no, you have a lot of rooms in your house, right?
I have a second bathroom.
Yeah, yeah.
Because I know that my employees might come here.
Yeah.
And I don't want them in my pristine fucking golden bathroom.
But that's where you—that's where you're showering right now in your pristine fucking golden bathroom.
Yes, I'm the Donald Trump of bathrooms.
Yeah.
Oh my god, I'm dying.
So it's impossible.
So it has
seriously?
A wall to keep people out.
Yeah.
Oh,
like,
yes!
So describe your bedroom. Like, what's in your bedroom, Arthur? Or Dante?
I think we have described this before. It's got, like, all those Palestinian artifacts, like, expensive, and now that the Middle East has been glassed.
Yeah, yeah.
Extremely rare, like, rugs on the ceiling, on the walls.
I'm imagining a giant oil painting of yourself above the bed.
Yeah, I think we did mention that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. What type of pose you got? You got, like, a thinking man's?
No, I feel it's.
Is it like the Kramer painting? Is it like the Kramer painting?
It's Napoleon on a horse.
Oh, okay. Are you like naked on a horse or something?
You know what? I feel like I'm probably in like a spandex shorts type thing that I designed myself as a fashion designer.
Yeah, your skin's equivalent for like you know.
This was it was definitely for my minor in college.
All right.
Oh my god.
Like, you know, I felt that the painting
performance underwear
needed a little bit of inspiration, and this was the best painting, so I bought it off of a person that made it.
Yeah. All right. Fair enough. So you guys are in this gaudy fucking room. I imagine it's all like dark reds and like golds and shit. And, you know, and you're having this conversation with Dante through the fucking door of his bathroom.
Who's having the, like, I am?
You and, Einar, I suppose.
Einar, like, there, definitely.
Einar, god damn it. So, like, I'm gonna drop, like, the whole stupid thing that I was doing with, like, my shirt pulled up, and I'm just gonna walk away while he's talking to him. Dante, I'll talk to you some other time.
I'm talking to you, Takahara.
Well,
I'm taking Einar out with me tomorrow night. You can be available for anything else, so plan your evening accordingly.
Plan my evening accordingly? You're the one with a hit on your head. Yeah. Boyfriend came to town. Ex-boyfriend came to town with his 12-year-old girlfriend. And looks like you're their next target.
I'm very disgusting.
And had I known that he was into girls like that, I probably would have never dated him in the first place. But the bitch tried to kill me downstairs in the lobby while you guys were gone.
I'm curious, Takahara.
Gordon shot her in the head.
I didn't shoot her in the head.
I'm going to give a very sternly worded warning to Jordan.
Oh, well, I let him know the next time they come in to just shoot the bitch, okay?
I have
Lady Freya, wait!
Shoot bitches.
Whoa. You saying they both threatened Lord Helsin and physically harmed yourself.
And I pull my shirt down to, like, almost, like, the top of my tits. I'm like, seriously? Yes, they did. Do you see this shit?
Yeah, there's, like, a karate chop on her neck. Like, you notice it instantly.
Like, I'm out the fucking bedroom door. I'm going to fucking Heimdall's room.
Where the fuck are you gonna go?
Which one's Heimdall again?
Yeah, not then me.
Yeah, Band is Heimdall.
Okay.
Right. Yeah. Yeah, I'm in there.
I can't keep up with this shit, man. Like,
kick the door down to Band's room.
Oh,
I'm in there. I'm compiling like it's a 37 second a series of clips of the best of from my troll bot because I know that that's about how long I can get Dante to be interested in it.
What type of music backing have you got on this thing? Like, what's going on?
X-Con, give it to me, X-Con.
No, no, it's like some techno stuff, and like for
Dante's
no reason.
Favorite song is Party Rock Anthem.
Okay,
hell yeah.
and like the screenshots of like the text like zoom in and out to the music.
Yes, I just flat foot kick down your door.
Is like the introduction like 40 seconds long and the video is like 20 seconds in total?
It has an outro as well. That's like,
I'm lay my hand on the back of Heimdall's neck and like, press his face and be like, use your sorcery to look into the aether and find me who has attacked the Lady Freya. Do it!
Like, wait, what? Who attacked her? She's, when did this happen?
You will look through the prismatic lens into the realm of mortals and find them for me, Heimdall.
Look, I can get into the cams if that's what you mean. Oh, let me see here. I'm just gonna go and start sorting through camera footage of the day.
Yeah, okay. That's a library search. And remember, you have a plus two. What did I say? Two?
Plus two.
Yeah, yeah. So yep. Roll that up.
Okay.
Higher you get, the more quickly you do it. But with a 10, yes, we're doing a 10 will take you like... Do. Okay, wow. Good stuff.
Wow.
Yeah, so no, you... Yeah, you just like go back.
What is this?
You just like instantly like instead of starting from the start, you're just like, well, if I just roll back a couple hours, I'll probably find it pretty quickly, right?
So, it's only like 15 minutes ago. It's fine.
Yeah. So no, you find it pretty easily, and it's literally just like it's just there's no audio, right? So it's just basically like have you ever seen like security cam footage of like it's just literally a series of like. Photographs.
It's weird when you're watching it. Yeah.
Yeah. It's like a series of photographs, sort of thing. And like one is like Takahara and these two people talking, and then the next one is like her turning around. The next one's her like on her knees with a knife on the neck. And then like there's a couple that are just the same, almost with like you know heads moving and stuff like that. And then like there's one pulling her hair back, and then this karate chopping coming down is like.
Band is watching, and he's also like play by playing it. He's like, "Oh, he's got her hair! Oh, she's going for the karate chop! Oh, right in the neck!"
Heimdall, make the demons in the box. Oh, show God. Me this painting.
Well, she is really tiny.
I want you to print for me like the picture of like both
the faces. Yeah, I get the best like zoom in and enhance I can, and start printing it out on art.
Well, since it's the 80s.
It's coming, like mate. Quadrant 4. Enhance again.
So it's like God. So here's what I'll allow you to do, right? You can make a program that can like render out the face more clearly if you want, but it'll be a super hard roll. It'll be like a 25 because the technology at this point in time is so bad. Fucking bad.
So yeah,
bad.
Maybe I'm like not a problem, and then like I'm like about to print, and then I just realize I just have like kind of like a blob.
On yeah, the screen. It's basically just like a gray blob with like black parts where the nose and mouth are. So it's like and the eyes. So it's like it basically just looks like some fucking cartoon character at this point. So
I'll turn to Einar and I'm just like, look, we've got to get him. But I need a clearer picture. I'm just going to check in. I've got to do a little bit of cleaning up on this image, okay? It's just going to take a few minutes.
Of course, Heimdall. Do what you must. I'll return shortly. I'm going to go through. How thick are the walls here?
Okay. Oh, my God.
Pretty thick.
Yeah.
Pretty thick. You're not
it's
going
a, it's,
they're
it's,
nice walls.
It's a
not
nice
just
wall.
Like,
yeah.
It's not, Dante, I have a body of 11, and I have enough drugs to take me to a 15.
I will destroy you if you go
Dante.
Through my
wall. I would be willing to go toe-to-toe with you. If I can't go through the walls, I will actually exit through the door I kicked down and go back into my room and start loading up on all of my heavy gear.
You will apply your gear so that you can walk through a wall.
Oh my
Zephyr,
God.
Is there something you need from me? I'm currently scrubbing my balls.
What exactly did you mean by clear my schedule? What are you
I'm
guys
not saying
doing
clear
to him?
Your schedule. I'm taking Ina and Band out for a night.
And what do you plan on doing?
Visiting a strip club and introducing Einar to the concept of women.
Do you think Einar would legitimately sleep with somebody that isn't, like...
I intend to find several Valkyries. Possibly at least two, perhaps three or more that he can sleep with at the same time.
Well then. Okay. Have fun with that.
Did you want me to set him aside for you? I know you just lost your boyfriend. What is it they call it for people that have that issue? Rebound sex? Something like that? I've honestly never had this happen. Explain to me if you need this.
Oh my God, Dante, why are you
saying these things?
He's like... Oh my God!
Kind of like a plebeian problems that I.
You know what, Dante? That's actually a great idea. You know what? I'm going to solve your problem and save you some money at the same time. Goodbye. I'm going to be in
I mean, Ben and I are still going out. He already made the appointment. But if you are going to tap that Einar, please wait until tomorrow night. But yes.
Yo, I am Dave. Like, while Heimdall is making me these pictures and like doing his magic,
yeah.
I'm going to be carrying boxes of ammunition and grenades and rockets down into my van.
Okay, I'm going to roll this. I need a good one if we're going to have a good image of these fuckers.
Yeah, so you
I
need
think
a 25.
Be...
Oh, okay.
Oh.
So yeah, I mean,
out,
like...
It just comes out kind of more jagged instead of rounded. But
yeah, like you don't really get a clear picture of who this person is from just those searches. I mean, you can... Like, it's kind of like how you can't really pinpoint what the Midnight Animal people are from, like, security footage because they're just... Like, high resolution is not a thing in Cyberpunk. High resolution is, like, 640 by 480 at best. You know,
I was
like,
reading in the book, and I was just like, this is fucking pathetic. Those poor fuckers.
Like, 15 by 15 LED screens are, like, fucking what? Like, you know, like...
on your computer? Wow.
Yeah. Like, CRTs, big fucking chunky computer screens, you know, that sort of stuff. Yeah. Yeah.
So... Can I come out of the shower now in, like, my middle gear?
Inside your middle gear, yeah.
How long is... Do you think Dante's going to take anything other than a long, luxurious shower after having sex
with
a woman?
I mean, you're stacked... He's taking, like, 10 minutes to resolve an image, and you're, like, stacking ammo.
Yeah, no, you can totally come out, yeah.
I'm going between my van and the apartment, like, taking all of my weapons, all of my ammo, all of my grenades.
So you're going into your room?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so you go into your room, and I walk in behind you, and I look at you, and I'm like, I need you to help me with something.
Of course, Lady Freya. I am already engaging in the vengeance of blood.
I have been defiled.
It'll take some time to track him down.
I need you to purify me.
Okay. All right.
Barash is just kind of sitting there watching all this go down. He takes a sip of his drink, and then he turns around.
Such a dragon cigarette, yeah.
All right.
He's just like, the soap opera is getting a little bit too creepy for me.
I am, like, Einar, this is on you. If you would like a seduction roll to be made, it can be. Otherwise, you can decide however you want to.
I believe, in all honesty, both, number one, Einar has too much respect and... Not even respect. He has too much, what's the word for it? Reverence for Freya.
Mm-hmm.
To ever even consider that she is offering sex.
Okay.
100%. He has no idea.
So you
even
want...
if he did.
Yeah.
He's Einar. He's never had sex before, and he appears to have no concept of it. Nor any desire for it, specifically.
Okay.
His only desire is to serve the gods.
Okay. So maybe you take it literally
get to
more than
duty,
figuratively.
Buddy.
Yeah.
So I don't think there's any way he would ever interpret this as a seduction.
Okay.
Attempt a seduction.
Well, I don't know. I mean, so what difficulty would you like to set the seduction at? So, keeping in mind that a
25 is near impossible.
25
right?
Well, is okay. Near impossible. So,
okay, so let's just imagine here. So, Einar has a very high human perception. He's like a 17 human perception.
Yeah.
But at the same time, he has no frame of reference for what is happening
mm-hmm.
right now.
Mm-hmm.
But he is a human. He mm-hmm. is a man.
Yeah.
So he's probably had
his loins stir the same way as anyone else.
Exactly. He's probably had some very confusing moments throughout his life where he's not sure what's going on.
Yeah.
And this
sure.
could be. So, I mean, I don't know. Maybe like a 20?
A 20. Okay.
Well, no. Here's the other thing that we have to remember here is that Einar is willing to serve the goddess. So if the goddess just says, strip naked and do me, he would do it.
It. Right.
So,
you know that's true.
Thanks,
she could just say it's some sort of ritual.
Hey man, this
heart.
Is
you know it to be true. I know
this happens to be a very adult game. Okay, so characters having sex with each other is completely within the realm of possibility.
Sure, so, but it'd be hilarious if this was the opposite. If this was Dante, for instance, it'd just be like very well.
Yeah.
All right. Yeah, I say a 20.
20. Okay, Siren, if you would please give us a seduction check with a DC of 20.
Okay, so I have a question. So I have an IP currently of 14.
Mm-hmm. What is your seduction level right now?
3.
So in order to go from 3 to 4, you will need 30 IP.
Okay, cool. That's all I need to know.
Yeah.
I thought you would need 40.
No, from 3
to 1, 20 to 2, 3 to 30.
No, from 0 to 1, it's 10. From 1 to 2, it's 10. From 2 to 3, it's 20.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
2 points is...
Mm-mm-mm. Oh, okay. So, you know what? For the first time in your life, like, maybe you stop what you're doing and you feel something like,
oh, I believe
stirring.
It.
You know out of context, like maybe she's sort of like doing the thing where she puts a, like she closes the door behind her and her hands are behind her back and she has that sort of bottom lip bite going on or something mm-hmm. along those lines.
Or maybe she's really literal and she just closes the door and just drops trial.
I don't think that would be the case, but Siren, you're able to interpret, you do this however you like. But in my eyes, it's more of like a, you know, you're propositioning without forcing it. But you can say it in any way you like.
So pretty much, like, yeah, I would close the door behind me. I'd walk up to him. And I would tell him, like, seriously, I have been defiled by the enemy. I need you to purify me in the only way you know how.
Okay, I'm going to reach down into, like, my little battle harness or whatever. I'm going to pull out a syringe, like a hypo, and just jab her with it.
Oh, fuck. Oh, of course.
Well, let's not jump to extreme conclusions here, typical. Remember, she was 1 point away from making you do what she wanted.
And dude, okay, first of all, I'm injecting her with a mixture of LSD and ecstasy.
Yeah, sure.
So that should be fun. But uh-huh. I mean, so yes, I feel, and like, let me rationalize this for you. Sure, like, sure. Einar, from the very beginning, has put himself in the way of death. He's put himself into situations protecting, using his body to shield mm-hmm. Freya mm-hmm. in his mind. He yeah. has sought her for advice, sought her for guidance. He sees her as both his protector and his guide through mm-hmm. the strange world that he is now living in.
Yeah.
So he already has, to me, Einar already has a very deep emotional connection to Zephyr.
So is this more of like a you yourself or Einar himself isn't really sure of how to react in this situation and that's where he goes to first?
I think Einar in his past, like on some base level he understands, like, yeah, he may find something through the use of these mind-altering substances. But yeah, it's more or less, it's really just an escape for him. He has the mind of a child and the maturity level of a child. He's a child soldier who's sure. raised in this refugee zone. He was forced into helping the militia or whatever gangs that were in the streets from a young age. So he's never really matured past that point. He's never developed any sort of rational, real, like mature, responsible relationships with anybody.
Yeah.
So he has these very romantic concepts. He has these very grand, sweeping ideas of what the world is like. He idolizes even a sociopath like Dante, you mm-hmm. know, because he sees him as being an agent of the gods and of the fates.
So,
okay,
this god so that you let's what is the god that you've interpreted Takahara to be?
Freya.
And what is she in terms of a god?
The goddess of love, fertility, and battle.
Okay, so maybe you see this as actually, like, before you saw her as, like, something other than what she actually is, and maybe now you see her as what the gods interpret her to actually be. A god of love and fertility. And maybe for the first time Einar is actually seeing this. But his reaction is well and truly within the same realm as what you'd imagine. Now, Siren, you were mentioning something, but I would like for you to make a reflex check to see whether or not you actually get stabbed with it, unless you're willing.
Yeah, because I'm going to say, if he's going to stab me with this, she's never done drugs before. Mm-hmm. So if he stabs her with this and she takes it, the first thing she's going to do is, like, just be all over him.
Okay.
The minute that the ecstasy, like, and the LSD kicks in, she's gonna grab onto him for, like, dear life and, like, immediately latch onto him.
Okay.
Because she's not gonna know anywhere else to go. She's not gonna know what to do. She doesn't know how to react. So the first thing she's gonna do is just seek out, like, anchor with him.
Okay. So we can sort of leave this here, if you like. If you want it to be ambiguous as to what actually happened, you two, we can leave it ambiguous. Otherwise, we can go into detail.
Where was my choice for this?
I mean, you literally said go to my penis website and look at my penis. I mean, that was not much of a choice.
That was your choice, yeah.
But I like, in terms of two...
Dave, blood shame
in yeah,
penis sure. Right now. Dave, my level of comfort is fairly robust.
Okay.
Within good taste. Within
and
good
I
taste.
Feel pretty confident I know where Siren's comfort level is. Okay.
Sure.
All right, so... Yeah, so... Takahara, after being injected, like, maybe you see... Einar, her pupils just go, just expand, right? And you know this as being like, for you personally, it's almost like some sort of like guidance or opening to the gods above.
This is exactly how Einar would interpret this. Yeah. So like Einar, like once he sees her pupils go wide, he's like, "You are seeing beyond the veil." And
so
he'll pick her up, like gather her into his arms, and carry her over to the bed and lay her down, and just like. Sort of questioningly, like, look down, like, he doesn't know what to do.
So,
like,
at this point, I'm going to say that maybe when you pick her up, Takahara will start, and maybe you can see this however you like, Takahara, but I imagine your character would then, at this point, like, initiate just romantic attachment. Like, you know, we're talking, like, you know, just start giving him hickeys on his neck and that sort of shit, too. So... like, you know, just going at it like
hardcore.
Still in
my armor with all my fucking weapons on my body. Oh, like,
yeah, no, he's
gonna take a while to like
strap.
Oh, okay. Yeah, for some reason, I was imagining you didn't have your helmet on, but you know, anyway,
I was literally ready to step out of the building. And
okay,
start
fair enough.
People.
Yeah, all right. So maybe you're just doing it regardless. Like maybe you're just like on the visor or something like that.
Yeah, she's on one, man.
So. The only thing stopping you two from engaging in this is your armor. What are you doing about it?
I mean, like I said, me personally, like, I'll pick her up, lay her down in the bed, and like just like put my hand like on her shoulder and hold her there, like while I kneel by the bed, and just like look, like try to observe what is going on.
So there's not much observing going on because she's literally not letting you go.
Right. Ooh, and like, okay. I'd be trying to. I'm trying to like pull your armor off. Trying to get to you.
I'll just shake my head and be like, the will of the gods is mysterious. And just start taking off my armor and my weapons.
Alright. So, is this happening?
Yeah.
That's what Einar's doing. I mean... And in the way that a extremely strong, inexperienced lover would be, like, taking... Not just being gentle, but like being extremely hesitant into doing anything because his hands have only been used to murder and to kill, like to break people with his bare hands and to rob them of their life and send their spirits to Valhalla. Mm-hmm. So he has no concept of being tender and of
so
loving
maybe
a
maybe like half like after the initiation begins, it's sort of like a you're like maybe Einar like is like too rough. To the point where
I would say the opposite. Like Einar is overcompensating for his strength and is not like he knows. Like he is
right, he doesn't
a man
want to destroy her.
Exactly. So like treating her too gently, like treating her like she's going to fall apart and break if he touches her too hard.
And on the opposite side of things, the drug Takahara is going to be the exact opposite. She's going to be like extremely engaging. She's going to take the initiative in every instance. She's going to like almost try and be in command. And maybe for the first time, Einar, you're at a loss as to what to do. So you imagine, I'd imagine that you'd let it happen as she wants it to.
Can we get a play-by-play and actually roll initiative?
Listen, in terms of like character growth, I feel like this is a big moment. So I wanted to give it its reverence, you know?
I agree.
So... You know, if there's like jokes to be made here, it's certainly possible. But I feel like two player characters initiating a relationship like this needs to be explored, and that's why I wanted to go into it.
Can I have something else as well?
Yeah, sure.
First of all, this is the first time anyone has ever really curbed Einar's desire for vengeance and blood. Period. Ever.
Okay.
Like,
yeah.
Number two, from the opposite side of the scale, this is very directly Zephyr defying Dante. 100%.
Oh, yeah. Like, that's a good point. That is a very good point.
Because Dante was like, I will take him tomorrow and we will take his virginity. And she's like, no.
Sure, but you had no idea that that was what was happening.
True, right? Yeah.
I had no idea. But she, that's what I'm saying.
There was literally a line that I would like to go back to. You mentioned something, Arthur, is like, yeah, after, because we already have a...
I literally gave her permission.
I was like, why don't you just go bang him? And she was like, okay, I will.
Oh, okay. Like, I saw that. I was like,
it's all good.
Me and Dante got this.
I arranged this.
He did, literally.
Go do it. Fine.
Fine, it costs
Dante
less money.
Dante Inferno, more like Dante Cupid.
Inferno.
Dante Cupid, from now on. So we sort of like fade out on this tender, drug-fueled moment between these two characters. And you know what? It's probably like obvious to the other party members what's happening. Except for maybe Dante. I don't know if you're still in the shower at this point or not.
I'm like, jacked in like... I'm like doing hardcore programming.
True.
Right
so
now,
maybe the only one that notices it is Barash and maybe Dante. Dante, you're free to notice it if you like. Otherwise, like, yeah. But
actually, Barash is gonna have a bit of a moment and just be like, "What are all these people doing? There's things to be doing. Fucking like this. I mean, I haven't done that in."
Check your calendar. Yeah. Exactly.
I don't know. I'm probably not going to be like, hey, if you haven't done that in a while, come with us, because I actually hate Barash. I'm just going to ignore him.
Yeah.
No, you. I'm well, I mean, you're still in the shower.
Well, I'm inviting you to come with us.
Yeah. Okay.
I'm married. Eat.
So let's fast forward maybe an hour or two, if you guys don't mind.
I mean, probably 30 seconds is enough. Einar's never.
Yeah. But it's not about that. It's more like there's probably a lot more after that as well.
I mean, but what about the fifth?
Okay,
point, right?
So can we come in where I'm showing? We're just finishing the it's the outro clip from my clip that I'm showing Dante.
This
is very interesting right here. I really enjoy the way that the text goes in and out. It keeps.
You took me an extra 10 minutes. I'm glad you liked it.
Keyframe animation took me a long time.
Perfect. Excellent. This is why I pay you. Wait. No, it isn't. I pay you to do your job, and you haven't turned in your hourly reports.
Look, this was a lot more fun. It's working brilliantly. Anyway.
I don't care. Do you see me going out and having fun? No, I am always at work doing my job.
But it's like 1,000 trolls at once, just harassing a constantly.
I understand, and it's very important. That part... is perfect. That is exactly what I asked you to do. Making these videos, while hilarious, should be done on your personal time. Finish your hourlies, and then you can make another batch of videos for me.
Very well. All right.
All right. So, Siren. Sorry, Takahara. After, you know, you finished your thing, and you come down, because this is like a drug thing for you. More than anything. So maybe it's like afterwards, it's just like an elation period where like maybe 2 hours after the coitus, you're just sort of like in extreme ecstasy for like the next 2 hours, right? Because I imagine just being fucking high as shit when you do this would just be like, you know.
Yeah, because she doesn't do drugs, so like that hit her like a fucking brick wall. Like,
yeah, yeah.
Seriously.
Yeah, you'd be tripping.
Yeah, you'd be tripping. Yeah. So you know, it's definitely something that you come out of it, and maybe you've got like a hangover and a headache and some other things like that. But you also feel extremely elated as well. But you do have like a couple of messages on your phone.
So, at first, I'm gonna like look over at Einar.
Einar, are you still
in
the room?
Gonna, like,
are you still here? Like, what would you be doing?
Einar?
Yeah.
I feel like Einar, like...
This is your room after all, so...
Right, but if you could imagine, Einar has spent his entire life in service to this cult.
Yeah.
And then he was sent here by Rynulf to serve Lord Helsen and the other band
Actually,
of
can
the
can we just
Einar
touch on to touch on to the cult real quickly? What is their opinion on sex? Like, where do they stand on that?
I don't believe they have any. As far
like,
as I'm
they,
concerned,
are they
they
like?
Any,
do they stop
they're not
people
like,
from having sex? Like, how
no,
they
no,
work?
They're not. They're not like celibate or anything like that. I mean, they're they are supposed to be traditional, well, not traditional, but like neo-Viking. So like, you know, they're very well groomed and they have good culture and good society.
I'm thinking sex is like a reward in the cult.
I would say no.
No,
like, no, it's not. No, Nordic women were actually, there's a lot of instances when they were just as strong as men and just as adamant as men. So, absolutely. Like, you know, the whole idea of a woman being different than a man is not there.
Okay.
So exactly. It's an embrace between two people who care about each other.
And even, even Odin himself was considered to be both male and female.
Fair enough. All right. So, yeah, go continue with your explanation.
I was going to say, like, he's been sent here by Ranulf to serve Lord Helsin as his personal guard, as well as the other Vanar who have been gathered here to serve with him. So this idea that he has transcended his own mortality by laying with a god is probably pretty heavy for him right now, I would imagine. Not to mention, it's his first time. You know, he's 23 years old. He spent his entire life learning how to serve as a warrior. So I imagine he is deep. As deep as Einar's thoughts go, he's there right now.
Do you turn to drugs?
No, probably for the first time. He's confused and he's feeling things he's probably never felt before. And rather than drown them in a sea of psychedelic drugs, he's actually like trying to wrestle with them and probably having a lot of.
Do you actually stay in the room when you're done?
Yes, absolutely. Like, stay in the room in wonderment of what has just happened. Like, this is probably a paradigm shifting event in Einar's life.
Okay. So Takahara, yeah, he's still in the room with you. Maybe so, sitting at the end of the bed, maybe not in the bed, but just sitting there, just thinking.
Right. So as I see him, I roll over and I see him sitting there, and I'm like, of all the times that you've come to save me, to stop me from no longer being on this mortal coil, I could not see this being in any perfect moment or exchange between us. And I thank you, Einar. I thank you for all of this.
Einar, you done banging yet?
Yeah, Einar's gonna stand up. He's like,
we have some very important business to do.
Oh my god.
Einar's gonna stand up like, Lady Freya, I need time to consider what has passed. And I'm gonna walk out completely naked.
Yeah, fair enough.
Einar, did you enjoy the sex?
Lord Helsin, like, is unbefitting of a man of your station, a god even, to disparage the nobility of such a fine woman as Lady Freya.
What? I am not disparaging her at all. I'm asking if you had fun while having sex.
There's nothing wrong with having sex.
Everyone has sex, Einar.
I know he's gonna turn like beet red, like from the tip, like from his hairline down to like the top of his chest, just like red. Heimdall, do you have those pictures?
Did you enjoy the sex or not? We're going to a sex club tomorrow night where people have more sex. If you would like to have more sex, you can come with us.
Yeah, it's gonna be great. Here's the picture. It's not the best, but
just snatch the picture out of his hand and just stalk back.
So let me tell you about these messages, Siren. They are from, what was...
Yeah, because then I'm going to roll over and then look at the messages as he, like, leaves the room.
So it's basically, what was her name again, sorry? The friend?
Tabitha?
Tabitha, yeah, they're from Tabitha. And they do give you the meeting place of a gentleman called R. And they would, she basically just puts in the note, like, he's expecting you.
Oh, is that right? Okay, like I talk to myself, you know, and I'm like, oh, okay.
Are you still in my room?
Yeah, I'm still in your room. Okay. I'm like, I'm gonna like, kind of like.
I stalk back in. I'm just like putting my armor on, like intently, like my face, like gruff, like it usually is, just very concentrating on the fact that or the task at hand.
Mm-hmm. So like, I roll out of bed. I start to gather up my clothes that I had, slowly start to put them back on, mm-hmm. and I like slowly walk past Einar out the room to tell Dante that I have Dante, I have another meeting for you.
Okay, just one second. I need to confirm whether Aina is coming with us to the strip club tomorrow. Aina, I can confirm that there will be several Valkyries present.
Lord Helson, the companionship of a Valkyrie would be nothing compared to that of a goddess herself.
Listen, you cannot always get the goddess. Sometimes you have to have a Valkyrie, my friend.
Dante, he could always have the goddess if he wanted her.
Well,
fine. If you want to stay in and bang her, that you can do that. Band, I assume you're still in?
Of course, mate.
All right, I know. We need to transform and roll out, as they say. We need to acquire some illicit material, bring the briefcase. Analyst,
Lord Helson,
what kind of weapons you'd like to see.
We must search out those who have threatened you and who have harmed the Lady Freya. They may have such illicit items.
They chopped her right in the neck. I saw the footage. It was right brutal.
They must be killed immediately. Her honor deserves no less.
We should kill them.
You guys fucking C6 a guy for not having a credit card and asking me if I was interested in him.
You guys? No.
Dante
Sierra.
Dante.
I didn't like get mad at him when he came back and told me about it, but I mean, whatever.
No.
Look,
it's within Lord Helson's rights to do
so. We've got a picture. I mean, and obviously, you know,
I'm looking at the picture. I'm like, did a child draw this?
Like, well, I haven't quite
finished
the program.
Is this supposed to be a digital photograph?
Well, it's meant to be rendered down to a smaller size. Maybe I hadn't got the algorithm right. Look, but she's seen him. Who was this chick? And I like hold up this like splash of ink on like a piece of paper.
If I could tell you who she was, I would tell you. I don't know who she was. I've never seen her before. Garrett has always come here, like, not here, but he's always met me by himself. I have no idea who this girl is.
Maybe we should check local high schools or elementary schools, whatever that guy is into.
No.
Look, well,
for her is a waste of
banking,
time.
It is. Dante, I agree with you. Because when they want to kill Dante, they will find him. And we will
be
waiting.
They want to kill Dante?
Well, I'm sure they want to kill all of us. But, yeah, Dante would be one of them. Because of the C6 under the car.
I wasn't even present.
Are they still mad about that?
Yeah, they're so mad about it.
24 hours ago. Isn't that how long it takes someone to get over this kind of thing?
They need somebody to supply them guns. Do you have somebody that can supply them guns?
The whole purpose was for them to give me guns. Of course,
yeah.
I don't have guns to give them. They
right?
are supposed to be giving me the guns.
Well, we need to find them somebody that can give them guns in order for them to leave you alone.
I'm going to be very clear here, Zephyr. The only thing I will give them are several packets of C6.
Well, you know what? At this point, I'm okay with that.
Yeah, so Einar walks back out, like, we will give them as many rounds as their fragile human bodies can hold.
Okay.
Right.
You know, Einar, you keep saying that they might be human, but I suspect that they are servants of Loki.
Indeed. Though humans have been known to serve Loki. Those who would raise a hand to Lady
Freya. I'm fairly certain that these are definitely devils in human form.
Very well.
When we kill them, we're actually going to
have
pure fragile bodies as well. Make sure to bring the gasoline with us in case we need extra purification.
My Lord Helson, since your times, we no longer use naphtha or Greek fire. We use what is called woolly peat or white phosphorus.
No,
it burns much hotter.
I literally hold up like a newspaper article. We use choo, C-H-O-O-H.
Yeah.
It's the specific blend that is found in all of our vehicles now.
Well, actually, when Einar says they needs to gear up, just the light goes off in Barash's head, and maybe nobody even notices, but he just kind of goes, walks over, and picks up like a thing for Einar, and he kind of hands it to him, and it's just a sword, and then he slinks down a device onto like the hilt of it, and then when he like clicks the trigger, it just starts sparking up, and he's just like, this isn't what you requested, no?
What the fuck is that?
It's sword that go electric.
Wait, what?
Broker, and like, I'll clap my hands on his tiny, frail shoulders, like, you are a true ally in this war against Loki.
So, remember, this one has a -2 to attack.
Yes, yeah. To attack, absolutely. I'm never going to use it except to kill people with, ritualistically.
Yeah, okay.
It'll be fine.
Alright, so, yeah, just throw that in your weapon slot as well, if you can. That way.
Got it. What's the damage on it? Do we know?
It's just a monokatana with -2 weapon on it, and you can have... you know, the electricity.
Can I add a stun to it or something?
Yeah, like you can add a taser effect on there. We'll work out what that is later. All right. How about we take our final break and then we can come back to you guys if you want to work. So, we've got a gun deal. The second gun deal for the show to go down. Tell me what you guys are doing to prepare. You have a location that you need to go. It's outside of Night City, in some sort of, like, warehouse. For, like...
Perfect.
Boxes.
I mean, I banged the shit out of this chick to get the deal, so I'm assuming... All we need to do is put Einar on, like, ground control and just walk on in there.
Yeah,
there's
pretty much.
There's no way
yeah.
she'd betray me.
Yeah, no. Most fixers tend to make sure that their business comes first, right? So, in a lot of cases, like, their pride in the work that they do is, like, you know, they wouldn't work with anyone that they wouldn't trust or that hasn't come from a credible source. So they don't put themselves in dangerous situations in a lot of cases. However, you are a dangerous man, as it turns out, Dante. So, you know, that's why you were able to get away with murdering that guy so easily last time without him having backup. And word has not spread yet of this. So as far as, like, fixers are concerned, you are still in the clear. Like, a lot of fixers do business in an isolated place without any sort of backup because... You know, if you bring guns to a gun deal in terms of security, it makes people edgy, right? And that's the last thing you want to happen in a gun deal. You don't want edgy, you know, feelings coming from the people that are buying from you. So, yeah.
Actually,
I want to
see if I can't jury-rig together some, like, discreet bugs.
Well, the jury rig and discrete don't really go hand in hand, unfortunately. Like, if you want to create discrete bugs, that's actually a role that you have to make that isn't related to jury rig. Jury rig is like, oh, I really real quickly need
That'd
to
be electronics,
slap,
wouldn't it?
Yeah, I really real quickly need to slap together like a bomb, and like it'll just be like a can of gasoline and like a fuse or something like that. It wouldn't be anything elegant. If you want elegant, that's like crafting. Jury rig is like the opposite of discreet. So,
all right. Well, that's not something I can do, but something that I actually was interested in from the last time that we dealt with the dealer was the idea of replaceable parts that were easily unidentifiable, if you would.
Mm.
You mean, you know, like something
like a drum for a gun and like a laser sight and like a scope and like a silencer. Yeah, okay. Mm-hmm.
I want to see if I can actually craft together some prototypes.
Sure. Is this what you're doing when everyone else is going for a gunsmithing? Like, are you going with them? Like, what are you doing?
Well, no, this would just be, I guess, what Barash is doing. He knows that another deal is going to go down, and he wants to see if, you know, this type of stuff wouldn't work out with a fixer, and couldn't get us some clout, if you would.
So you want to bring these to the deal, essentially?
Just one or two, and just ask, you know... This would,
okay,
you know,
I'll tell you what. I will let you put together prototypes. Depending on your role, what are you rolling here? Weaponsmithing?
Yeah.
Okay, so depending on your role, you will, it, like, you know, 10 will be like a pass. I mean, it won't be amazing. And 30 will be like, holy shit, look how good I am. And depending on like the quality of stuff that you bring to this deal, the fixer will have a different reaction. So go ahead and roll up your weaponsmith for me. All right, yeah, you crit that. Wow, you literally have... You rolled a 10, a 7, and then you have a 10 and a 10 in your skills. That is... Okay. Got a 37.
So these are like burner prototypes. These are stuff so, like, if they were mass-produced, they could easily be made unidentifiable if you know what you're doing. So it would be like...
No, oh, well, okay, so the reason why things are identifiable is rifling, right? And... Mm-hmm. Like material, like actual, like, you know, serial numbers and stuff like that. So to make things unidentifiable, you change the rifling of a silencer and you remove the serial number. But if you're building it yourself, there is no standard rifling. There is no serial number that goes into it, unless you keep your own style of serial number, in which case it wouldn't be identifiable in any sort of like record keeping process or anything like that.
What I mean to say is that this is like prototypes for a weapon.
Yeah, just hang on.
That does make sense.
Yeah, typical. Does that make sense with the rifling stuff?
I mean, the rifling, any kind of situation with rifling is going to be an exchange between the twist of the rifling, like how much it inhibits the passage of the round through the chamber or through the barrel, and the expansion of the gas itself. So you've got basically three forces. You have the action, which is going to be working against the expansion of the gas. You've got the round traveling through the barrel that's going to be working against the expansion of the gas. And you have how much force is being applied to the round as it's being forced through the rifling. The tighter the rifling, the greater the force against the action is going to be based on the expansion.
But a more like accurate shot, the title of the rifle.
Absolutely, yeah. The more it spins, the more accurate it is, generally speaking. Okay.
So the idea here is, let's say I made the first Monsanto Joja rifling or whatever it was. I made it in such a way that it could be easily made to be a black market weapon.
So you wouldn't attribute that to Monsanto Joja Corporation then? Because the moment you attach it to a corporation is the moment it becomes legitimized, right?
And that's what the idea is. The idea is if there was a way to make something, or, I mean, even if it is just replacement.
So I'm going to tell you...
It's replacement parts that can't be identified.
So I'm going to tell you straight up, if you want this fixer to actually be happy with your work... You have to keep it out of the hands of Monsanto Joja Corporation.
That's fine. This is just me making some replacement parts that are just completely unidentifiable.
Okay, so with your role here, I'll allow you to create one piece that you can bring to the meeting with you. What is it?
Oh no, BC. What do you think?
You make it perfectly, but whatever it is.
Well, I'm just asking. Typical. What do you think would be a really cool thing to make? For a gun.
You're just making a barrel?
Sure. It's a rifling barrel that doesn't inhibit the shot, but also cannot. Makes an unidentifiable round.
Okay. Well, be sure to bring that with you. So, let's talk about this. You know what? Because you have a 10 in each thing, I would say you get IP for doing it so well, but you don't. Because you've maxed it out. Like, you can't get any higher than a 10, so... And you don't get generic IP either, so...
That's fine.
Yeah. You know what? Fuck it. I'll give you one floating IP that you can spend. It's not two for doing well, but, you know, I'm not going to penalize you for that.
That's fine.
So, yeah, you guys rock up to this warehouse. I imagine, Einar, you're on security patrol.
All right, real quick, just in case we do get into the shit, I did get, hopefully, an assault rifle from Einar.
Yeah, it's on the back. Let me double-check what you have. You have got my...
I have the page open for assault rifle.
Sure. You have got... I've got a couple burner Kalashnikovs, so that's probably what you have. Like,
okay, I've got an AA-80.
Yeah, exactly.
All right, just put that on your sheet.
If Kalashnikovs, you just happen to have a couple.
I mean, they're cheap. They're no super cheap. I have so much money. They're 550 EB. Like, Yeah.
Just take those Kalushnikovs down to market and sell them.
Why would we ever?
I think having an arsenal is more important than a couple of extra floating Eurobucks. Okay, so yeah, you're bringing a rifle. That's fine. Anyone else doing anything in particular? Siren, are you here with everyone? Oh, sorry, Tucker.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, okay. Yeah, because I have to make the contact with them.
Sure. All right. So yeah, you guys walk into the warehouse, and there is a gentleman there standing in front of three crates, and he has like an SUV type car with the open back as well, and he's like,
"Gentlemen and apparently lady, welcome to Oz Warehouse. Emporium and everything Oz? That you can want. Ah.
Your name is Ah.
Ah.
Okay. Mr. Ah, well. Let's do some business.
Mm-hmm. First things first, I need to make sure you have appropriate money.
All that murder could have been avoided if he had just done that in the beginning last time.
I'm like, Einar, bring the briefcase out.
Of course, Lord Helsin.
Do you kneel down in front of this guy?
Exactly, I will go in front of him and kneel down, and like, I'll have my assault rifle and my sling in the front, just have a hand on it, and then I'm gonna mad dog these guys. Like,
it's just one
whatever
guy.
Lord Helsin
it's
wants.
It's one guy, and he's not armed, basically.
Okay.
So.
That's fine.
Yeah, so you open it up, and we'll have the scene of like, you know, it's over your shoulder, Einar, and like his face illuminates with this glow of gold, and he just looks at the box, the briefcase, and he's like, "Oh my, this is very, very good. What would you like to purchase from Ah today?"
We'll go with everybody else. Like, what stuff do you guys immediately need? I, of course, need a grenade launcher with several grenades.
Chain gun.
Chain gun. It's a straight up chain gun. All right. So
I also need that specific rifle from Black Hand. I need a Toa Manufacturing Type 00 Kai.
Can you guys put this ammo into to go with it? The chat, please? Just type what you need. And like, put the rating of how much it's the rarity of it. That's all I'm interested in. And the cost. And I don't need the weapon stats. I just need the name, the rarity, and the cost, please. It's the briefcase from Pulp Fiction. Yes, that's exactly how Arthur described it. So that's exactly what it is. So,
yeah.
No one else wants anything from the weapons dealer?
No,
I'm just looking at typing it in.
Rifle.
I spent, of my 32 or 36,000 Eurobucks, I spent about 20,000 on weapons and ammo. And grenades. And
so,
weapons.
Virgil, you mentioned you wanted to get into heavy weapons, right? Do you want a heavy weapon? What is the rarity on that? It'll be like a number or a letter. Sorry,
available. Con? What? I don't know what that is.
So yeah. He will have to make a roll to see whether or not he has high rarity guns, right? But other than that, like, he'll pretty much have anything that you want as long as it's not super rare. And if he can get it, it'll take, you won't be able to get it today, essentially. So super rare stuff is like not available easily. So wow, you want a super rare cockerel? What's that? Is that a machine gun?
Or no, actually, that's the thing. I read the wrong one. This is more reasonable of what I want.
What's the
mine is a rare as well.
No, this is a 7.62 millimeter minigun.
Okay, so you don't want the first one?
No, that's fine.
Okay.
And
everything I have is rare.
Alright. So he's gonna have automatic grenade launcher. He's gonna have to make a 15 on his check here in order to find you guys what you need. So what do fixes use as their main skill? It's like street deal, right? Yeah, but that's what is that? I'm trying to work out what street deal actually is in terms of character statistics. Nope. We need.
So everything we're about to buy is owned by Monsanto Georgia, by the way. So don't use it to commit any war crimes or anything we'd get in real trouble for.
That's right, yeah.
Jeez.
Good murder's okay.
No war crimes.
Keep it on low.
Starting skills.
Oh, you guys
okay.
Are funny as shit.
Okay, let's take a look. Street deal.
Oh, you're getting a Miltech Mark V too?
Alright, this is the ability to deal with the underground information network. The street deal or fixer can uncover rumors, information, locate missing persons, blah, blah, blah. The higher street deal ability, the more information you can gather about the things happening around you. The more informants you have, the more security you have. Okay. Okay, so you can have access to things like crime family style weapons. Yeah, okay. Okay, so it's cool that he's rolling. Right. That's what I wanted to know. Okay. So cool. Whoa. Okay, you guys are in luck. Congratulations. D10 plus 9 plus 5. Oh! Okay, so he fumbles. But he passes. Let's take a look here.
He tries to rip him off, and we shoot him in the head. And then we're banned yet again from having
So Cool doesn't have a fumble table attached to
nice
it.
Nice things.
Which is interesting. Huh. So let me just...
Also laser rifle is possible.
Okay, so that's pretty high. So yeah.
You're like saying that like as he's like checking to see if he can get the stuff.
Also, I know it all shot, but if you happen to have a gun that shoots out lasers, I would appreciate it.
No.
So
not give him a gun that shoots out lasers.
So,
we're not covered.
So you would know this already? Lasers are biomechanical, so you need to have them implanted in your body in order for them to work.
We're definitely not doing that. That's ridiculous.
Yeah.
But I make my own.
The pool. All
right.
Okay. I make my own.
Good luck. The lasers in this game are literally like one shot, and they take like 24 hours to recharge on a wall socket.
He literally just makes a shark that fires one laser a day.
Yeah, one laser a day.
Up, like,
and then you have to plug the shark into the wall.
And just shoot them.
Oh my god.
All right.
Swimming around it.
How did you guys get access to my plans?
So,
in a shark tank, trying to...
So I imagine, like, what happens here, you sort of, like, you know, he's like, what would you like to buy from today? And then you just, like, you pull out a shopping list, essentially.
It's just
you hold it out and, like, does the stupid thing that happens in movies sometimes when they have a really long list and it rolls out in front of him. So he's just sort of scratching his chin and he's just like, I mean, he
You need a few days to get back to us on this.
Some of this stuff is really, really interesting material.
Pretty much everything on that list is highly illegal and restricted military.
He, like, puts his hand up to, like, stop you from talking, and he's just like, do not worry. We'll be able to find what you need. The problem is time. How quickly would you need such materials?
Just like, how quickly does the briefcase full of money get me that material?
Well, it is less...
Are we talking days or weeks?
It is less about how quickly I can get it for you and how quickly I have to work my contacts. You see, I can get it to you tomorrow. The problem is that someone might notice that something like that is missing. The longer it takes, the more
careful we can be.
How about not careful?
The cost will be the same, but when someone comes knocking for that grenade launcher with, you know.
That sounds like your problem, yeah. Not mine. However, I will give you several days in order to collect your goods. Mr. Band, how long does your convalescence require?
GM, how long? Until I'm all better. I have 4 right now.
4 days.
4 days?
You have 4 days to acquire the material.
Also, good sir, I have something of interest for you. And I take out the rifle barrel and I show it to him. I can make more. They make unrecognizable shots.
So he pulls out, like, a pair of reading glasses or something equivalent, and he puts them on, and he holds it up, and he's just like,
interesting. You say you made?
I made this in my workshop. I make more. If need be, that is. All depends on if I can get minigun for my gorilla.
He, like, he leans over, and he's just like,
do not worry. I have minigun right here.
And he walks, one moment, and he walks to, like, the back, and maybe he fluts around a little bit, and he comes back. He basically, like, has this giant, like, case, and maybe it's on, like, a wheel. Like, he's got, like, a trolley thing, and he's just, like, pushing it out. And then he, like, plunks it down, and he's like,
this is the...
What is the name of it? He didn't write the name.
It's just a minigun. You can name it whatever you want to name it.
Okay.
This is the resolutionizer.
I mean, it's obviously
that's
Vulcan
pretty good.
Minigun.
You could say that the most expensive part of this weapon is the fact that the ammunition will fire
nope.
so quickly.
Nope.
I'm not going to do that. I'm not doing that. So, I would recommend...
It costs $200,000 to fire a gun for 1 minute.
I would recommend buying lots of ammunition.
Yes.
I will make deal with you. If you can bring me... parts when I need them. It will help me to... disguise the weapons that you have requested. In exchange for helping me, you can take 2,000 rounds.
Yes, I do what I can.
All right. Here is the list of parts that I will need for these weapons. You have 4 days, I assume.
He, like, smiles at you, Arthur, when he says that.
To get these parts. And then I can guarantee that the safety of your crew will be more than what it would be without. Then our transaction has been completed. I will take payment now.
What was the name of the guy that we totally fucking murked? And by we, I literally just mean me.
Elisha.
And this guy's name is R.
Mm-hmm.
Mr. R, are you aware of a dealer named Elisha?
Give me a luck roll, real quickly.
Jesus. It's the worst. Why don't you ask me if I want to have my tonsils fucking removed?
Would you like that? I can arrange it.
Yeah, I've succeeded.
Right, he's like, yes, I know that despicable piece of shit. What about him?
He tried to rip me off on a deal last night. I want to let you know that people who rip me off on deals end up dead.
We don't make business by ripping people off. If he
Excellent.
Ripped you off, then he is very much a bad fixer. And God knows what's coming
to
him.
Put the word out. That anyone who tries to rip off Dante Fierro gets fucking messed up, and they'll end up just like Alicia. In fact, Zephyr, write this down very quickly. We're going to make up a new phrase on the street, which means don't fucking mess with me. It's slang. It's called by Alicia. We're going to
by
say
Alicia?
It often as possible. Write it down. I don't see you writing anything.
I'm writing it down. I'm writing it down. I'm writing it down, Dante. It's okay.
Excellent. Put the word out on the street, please. Thank you very much.
Oh, no.
Imagine you're pulling like a napkin and like some lipstick out and like writing.
Bye, Alicia.
Mr. R, I thank you so much for your service here. I look forward. Here is the delivery point for those crates. Just leave them with the attendant, Jordan. He will send them up to us.
He like nods and he like bows a little bit. And he's like,
would you like help putting 2,000 rounds and the revolutionizer inside of vehicle?
No, that's why we have Einar. He's very powerful.
Yeah.
Einar, go lift all the rounds at once.
I mean, is it 2,000? What caliber of the rounds are they?
They are 7.62 millimeters, and there's 2,000 of them.
That's actually not that bad. Yeah, I could lift that many 5.56 at a time in real life. So, I mean, I think Einar could do 7.62.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Should be a problem.
You have a body of 11, so you could literally lift, like, a car full of those if you wanted
to. Oh, yeah. Like Einar is stronger than any strong man in the world right now. Yeah. So, yeah.
Well, no, there's stronger people than you, but you are up there.
No, I mean, like, in actual current, like, real life.
Oh, yeah, no, yeah, most likely, yeah. All right, so that was a successful transaction. Like, I assume you leave the briefcase with this man?
Yeah, he gets the goods.
Arthur?
We're not ripping him off, right?
No, we don't leave the brief. We take the things out of the briefcase and hand it to him off camera. Okay. Maybe there's always someone standing in front of it, or it's like Raiden from Metal Gear Solid 2 when he's naked. There's always something blocking what's actually in the briefcase. Then I give the briefcase back to Einar.
I mean, did it ever leave his... Like, I thought that it was just implanted onto the back of his office.
Yeah, perfect. Yes, it's now on your back.
It's not even a briefcase. It's just like a compartment that only Dante can open in his armor.
It's a briefcase. It's a briefcase. Not some weird fucking thing that you guys have.
I mean, are you serious? Broker. We must find a more secure way to carry the Lord Helsin's treasures.
Fine.
Nobody dies while shopping today.
The person I know besides myself. I trust you implicitly to carry a briefcase.
All right.
Hey, uniform, mate.
Just like he just has a pallet of ammo in his arms, like, very well, Lord Helsin.
So maybe we can like fast forward to tomorrow night's like fateful endeavor at the strip club. What do you guys think?
I really feel like that's...
He's not going.
Next episode?
You want to do next episode? Okay, is there anything you guys want to do with the remainder of your day? Maybe check out, maybe do some surveillance on this other warehouse?
Einar has not fucking given up. He's going to find the people who harmed Lady Freya, and he's going to murder them.
All right, so how are you going to find them?
Yeah, can I, gosh. The thing is, I want to talk to Zephyr, but I have a feeling he's not...
Let me just stipulate, finding these people is going to be extremely hard. They don't make their jobs...
Right.
They're not good at their jobs because they're easy to be found, right?
When I asked, you said you didn't know her name and you'd never seen her, right?
Right.
Yeah, maybe I just...
Only we had somebody who knew this guy personally, and then we could use that bit of information to find more information.
I know him personally, but I don't know her.
We don't need to know her. We find him, we find her.
But I don't know him, like, obviously I don't know him that well either. Like, I thought I did because he was my boyfriend.
No. Roy, well, what's his fucking favorite TV show? I'll start trolling the nets.
Oh my god.
I'll start piling up the fucking...
Does he write fan fiction? Because I know plenty of people that do.
Look, it's a perfectly normal thing to start imagining scenes in your head about your favorite characters and them doing exciting things, so, you know.
Listen, this
is he into it?
I would ship that.
We know his phone number. Siren, you know his phone number. Zephyr.
Yes. Yes, I know his phone number.
Can we search for who is registered to said phone?
Well, considering the company he carries, don't you think it wouldn't be a throwaway phone?
Well, you can try.
Sure thing. So I give the phone number to Band.
Look, if he was, you know, spent some time with him, it might not be a bad...
So this type of thing, right? It's very much like if you want this information, you have to gain access to the place that they keep it, and then right. you have to find it inside that place. So
yeah, so this
much
is
like
be...
much like hacking in this game, as I've mentioned before, if you want to actually find information from a different place, you can't just from the safety of your home spend a bit of time hacking something because it's not connected. It really isn't.
All right.
So you need to actually go to a physical location. You need to either connect wirelessly while you're at that physical location or find a data jack to actually gain access to their subservice. And once you have access to their subservice, it's just, you know, you need to find what it is that you're looking for. So in this case, you're looking for, you have a number and you're trying to find out who it's registered to and who it's registered to and you know, what sort of information they've left behind.
So would they have that information at like a cell phone store? Like, would they have who's registered to what numbers when they, because they would have to assign new numbers?
Yeah. It connects to a main server.
Maybe. You know what? I'm willing to say at this point it works how like banks in America do when it comes to like transporting like checks and stuff like that. Sure, you can go to a location and you can register a thing, but at the end of a working day, those pieces of information are then taken to a hub where they're, you know,
processed.
Yes. That's how I'm going to say that just about anything that is connected to the net will work. If they have like, you know, places like storefronts and stuff like that. So that is a precedent that I'm going to set. For example, you could, you know, stake out a place and then follow the truck to like the HQ, for example. That is a possible way of finding the location and then assaulting it that way, if you wanted to find that information.
Well, I was going to say that in more real terms, it's probably that in their local network, the data gets wiped, but they still have a connection to a main server.
Yeah, they have
that
like...
main server would mean that it would be harder. You have to break into the local...
They have like 500 megabyte hard drives at the maximum in these places, right? So like... You gotta remember, it's the fucking 80s. Like, this is the type of place where you're like, yeah, I had 16 megabytes of RAM in this computer at some point, you know? Like, that's a lot of RAM. Mm.
Could I just make a call and, like, trace it to, like the last, like, out, you know, at least, like, narrow the search down to a part of the city to see where, like, the last outgoing hub was? Like,
I would say
be, like,
yes, if you
there,
had...
There.
If you had
stop
some...
there. It must be...
Yeah, I would say yes that, if yeah. you had a way of triangulating. Do you have a way of triangulating wirelessly?
Can I roll jury-rig?
You would have to first actually go to, like, cell towers and set up a device if you wanted to do it. Because remember, this is the 80s, and there All is, right. like, Wi-Fi
yeah, let's,
is, like...
Let's...
Not what it is today.
Let's set it up. Let's set it up and see if we can maybe just do it next episode. Let's just do some rolls to like hack something together, like something to throw on the cell tower.
Mm. I would allow that. Yeah, absolutely. So in terms of what you need to do, so this would be like an electronics skill. A jury rig skill would be like going to the cell tower and then like retrofitting it to do what you need to do.
All right. Well, maybe we'll just do one. Just do it that way. I mean, I'm like, I guess we'd just be like talking it over, and I'm just like, look, I could. It seems like I'll be able to, you know, narrow it down a little bit. But if we could somehow find out the last tower it was bouncing the signal off of, but we would somehow need direct access to at least one tower. To be able to triangulate to see when the last one hit. I almost feel like one of my old modems would be able to do the trick if we pulled it apart.
All I need is hardware and access to a device.
Alright, maybe we just take a ride then? Go find a tower up on a hill somewhere where it's, you know, concealed.
So, I guess me, Band, and Einar are going for a joyride out to a cell tower?
Sure. Yeah, go on.
Before we do that, I'd like to actually have this conversation in character. Like, basically, I was like, find these people, but like, that's sort of where we left the conversation.
Yeah, okay. So we kind of dropped off for a second, but we were in the middle of being like, you have the number, right? So maybe I get the number and I'm like just punching away some stuff at the computer, seeing if I can get a lucky hit off like the number belonging to something that's listed. I'm like, look, nothing, but we can find them. Don't worry, mate. And I'm like talking to Einar. I'm like, it's just going to be a little bit more complicated because we're going to need
them. They came and they threatened Lord Helsin in his own home.
Right, we'll find them in their homes. That's the whole point. So, but in order to find the homes and in order to get, you know, vengeance and everything, we're going to need to go on a little excursion, say? Going to have to go one of the pit stops on the Rainbow Bridge thing, if you catch my meaning.
What we need to do is we need to visit locations in which the world connects with the Rainbow Bridge. And me and Band here will work together to monitor it. And once we monitor it, it'll be able to tell us where this person is.
You are saying we must find a means of accessing the Bifrost, the realm between the mortal world and the gods.
Yes.
Yeah, because
that is where these miscreants will be found.
Well, we could peer down at them, right? Peer down and see their location and rain down with hellfire and whatnot.
Yes, I'm...
Actually, so once
your
we have
job
this
will be to make sure that if anyone comes by where we're messing with the boy valve, that you murder them real good.
Yes. Well, it is not murder. It would be honorable combat, Heimdall.
Right. You know, big ear speech.
Yes. Yes, Lord Helsin, this plan meet with your approval.
What do you think, boss? Gonna go on a quick run.
Quick run.
Actually, does Monsanto Jojo own anything like that?
No. They're small fish in a big ocean right now, so...
Okay.
Yeah, so what we're going to do is we're going to take my old, like, busted up deck that has, like, you know, still, like, modem pieces and, like, you know, plenty of, like, circuitry and wires. And, like, I'm sure we have, like, a bunch of duct tape and, like, maybe, like, a pocket soldering iron or something.
Okay. So I'm going to say that to jury rig this, you're looking at a 20, and you need to do it three times on the three towers in order to triangulate what you're doing. And I'm willing to just, like, leave this up to rolls. We don't really need to, like... Oh, no, there's security up there. There's not going to be security.
It's okay. So we get tower, to... So. We find cell towers. Yeah. All right, go for it.
So roll three?
Roll three, yeah. And you need to get a 20 on each one. Oh. Okay. Oh, no. So next one. Oof. Hang on a second. Let's see here. What is that, tech?
Isn't jury rig supposed to be connected to something?
Yeah, it's tech.
Well, it's not adding in my intelligence. Like, if you look at it, it's just doing the 10.
Yeah, it's just,
I have a 10 in jury rig, and I have a 10 in intelligence, so it's not adding the two together.
Well, let me see your character.
Wait a minute, it shows 1d10 plus 10 plus 0.
Yeah, it should be 1d10 plus 10 plus 10.
Oh. Yeah,
unless jury rig is not an intelligence skill.
Says your jury rig is zero, right?
Yeah, give me a second here. Why is it doing that?
It's rolling the ones again.
Int.
Well, it's adding a zero because it thinks it's adding something.
Yeah, I'm not sure. Like, this sheet might be broken.
Yeah, I don't think it's putting in the int.
Okay, so the first one, is, so the first one would be 25. So you're fine on that. The second one is still a fumble.
Where else is supposed to add tech, not int?
Do you want me to add jury rig to one of my intelligence skills and just go from there?
No, it's fine. We can just add it each time. So you got a 7. So you make it worse, plus 5 difficulty on the next attempt.
Plus 5 on the next attempt?
Yeah, so you're looking at a 25. To, like, to get the next one.
Okay. 23.
Yeah, no good. So you get one of the towers up and running, and maybe you're not aware of it until, like, you try and triangulate something.
There's too much interference.
Well, it's not so much that. You're not even sure what it is. But I think that's a good spot to leave it. So maybe we show, like, you know, there's a montage of you guys like doing it to some sort of 80s like hair metal pop music thing, like a Britney Spears or something like that. It's like, you know, it's all happy and stuff, and you guys are like high-fiving and like climbing like ladders and stuff, and you're all like smiling.
Like soldering
and
stuff on, and I'm like, that's me old ripped jaw modem. That thing was me first modem and me first deck.
Yeah, and it's just like a series of like, you know, like high fives and like maybe chest bumps and stuff like that, and you guys are like doing everything, and then maybe like you all like sit down. You know how they do that thing in like sitcoms when everyone sits on the couch at the exact same moment? And they all like slump Friends. Into a couch. Yeah,
I met your mother.
Yeah, that sort of stuff. Like all three of you do that, and then like maybe you know, Band is like, "All right, guys, we're gonna turn it on now," or something like that. You know, and like that's where we cut. It's like
next time on Die Party Night City,
and it's just like, "All right, guys, we're gonna turn it on now," and then it's like, "Bloop," and then that's it. Like that's like, you know, it's like, well, we already saw that, but thanks. So you know, let's do some shout outs then, huh? Mr. Everyone's favorite internal politics leader, Mr. Dante Fierro. Let's talk about you.
I'm Arthur Perkins. You can find me at AP Gaming Reel everywhere on the internet, including apgamingreel.tv.
Wow, you have a website now? Oh, no, you always had a website, didn't you?
Yeah. I always had one. Yeah. All it does is link to my Twitch page. It's only purpose. Secure I think it might be apgaming.tv. But yeah, anyway, I do a lot of tabletop role-playing stuff. I always play the bad guy, apparently, no matter what.
Best guy.
Well, at least in all the cyberpunk stuff you've ever done, you've always played a bad guy, which is super weird. He did that in the
Vulgaris. He's just too used to it from being a GM.
Yeah.
He's just a bad guy.
No, wait. No, I played a good guy in that game. Everyone was like, let's murder him. And I was like, are you sure we can't give peace a chance? And they were like, murder, murder, murder. And I was like, are you
very well?
Sure, we can't give peace a chance. Only way I can get experience points is if we resolve this without combat. And everyone was like, all right, we're definitely killing them now.
Alright, up next we have the young and bountiful Takahara, aka GamerSiren. Tell us where they can find you on the internet.
Yeah, you can find me at twitch.tv/GamerSiren. You can also find me at Tenshiya Okada, one word.
No one knows how to spell that.
On Twitter. I know. If you guys go to my Twitch, you can find all the information there. My Facebook's there. My Twitter's there. Not like anybody uses Facebook, but, you know, I'm just saying. And come May 5th, when I graduate from college, I will be doing Grand Theft Assholes on my Twitch page. We're going to be playing a bunch of crazy Grand Theft Auto games, being a bunch of jerks, because I'd be super drunk.
Nice.
Yes.
Speaking about super drunk... Mr. Typical GM, tell us.
Right? I feel like that's fair. Yeah. That's fair.
I saw you like... knocking back shots all episode. So like,
I mean, straight from the bottle.
There was two shots tequila, and then there was two bourbons.
Yeah, I like, saw. I wasn't gonna say anything, but like, you know, yeah.
No, it's fair. It's fair. It's harsh, but fair.
Yeah.
I'm Typical GM. You can find me on Twitch mostly and Twitter, but I never tweet anything, so mainly just here. And again, just I had a ton of fun. Arthur's his generalship of this motley crew of retards is hilarious. It was just a great night, great night role playing. Thanks, Dave, for putting this all together for us and having us be a part of it. And that's it. If you guys like what you saw, obviously go to everybody, click on their names, follow them on Twitch and whatever other social media they have. And that's me. I'm done. Thanks for being here.
All right. Everyone's favorite New Zealander. We got Mr. Zirkun Thief. How you doing, bruv?
Thank you, bruv. Just hope everyone come over and check him out on Twitch, bruv. Bro, come and watch me, bro. It's so epic, bro.
Seriously, though, if you want to see some shit, stop by twitch.tv/zircon5. I'll be doing stuff lately. I've been doing a bunch of crazy, weird sound synthesis experiments, and I'm going to start streaming them.
You know, there's a game based on sound synths. I'm pretty sure it's just called Sound Synths. But, you know, maybe that's right up your alley. Like, I don't know.
Test now with sound synthesis. Do it all day.
Yeah.
So, yeah, come swing by. And thanks, yeah, thanks to all the players for a lovely game today. I had a ton of fun smiling and laughing the whole time. And chat, lovely chat. You guys are killing me. I love you guys. So fun to play in front of an audience. And Dave, thanks for hosting.
No worries. Good night. Man. And last but not least, everyone's favorite techie, mad scientist, gorilla lover, we have Chip in it. Tell the people where they can find you.
Hey guys, I'm Chip in it. I have a Twitter and a Twitch. I barely use them because I'm busy working. But hey, if I do play on something and you follow me, you might see that notification. And if you do, I'll be here for you.
Awesome. And last but not least, we have me. Hi, everyone. My name is Dave. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed tonight's episode of Die Party Nightcity. We have plenty of more role-playing stuff, if that's what you like. You can find all the archives over on my YouTube channel, Hensicle. And if podcasts are more your Flavor Flav, you can head on over to soundcloud.com/Die Party and check out all the podcasts we got there.
There's plenty of them.
In terms of what we're doing this week, tomorrow I'll be over... No, not tomorrow. Tomorrow is a free day, so I'll probably be doing more Dark Souls tomorrow. Wednesday we'll be over at AP Gaming Reels channel for more Edge of the Empire, Shadows of War. That's going to be fun. After that, on Thursday, we have Die Party Sin Eaters, which is a World of Darkness Geist of Sin Eater game. That stars Zircon 5 here, but he is not New Zealander in that one. And some other people as well. And that's pretty much it, guys. Thank you very much for watching. Be sure to follow if you haven't. It really helps us out. And thank you very much to everyone who did follow tonight. I love you all. We out of here. Peace.
Bye.
Have a good night.